chat.
Hold on, wait a minute.
What episode it is, man? Episode 16, man. Tell me that shit again, man. Popping the ignorance in the motherfucking building again. Come on, y'all, tap the fuck in. Y'all see what he's saying? Nah, tap the fuck in, man. It's Popping the Ignorance, episode 16, man. To my left, I got my boy Montel in this motherfucker.
And we're starting on time.
We are starting up.
It's your boy.
To my far right, I got Quay in the motherfucking building. If y'all know who it is by now, man, it's this little ass nigga D-Lo in this motherfucker.
Yeah, man, you know what I'm saying? The real D-Lo, you know what I'm saying?
I'm not trying to hear that bullshit. Man, listen, you know who I am. If you don't know by now, it's D-Lo 816, man. It's Popping the Ignorance, episode 16. What you about to say, hoe ass nigga?
Nah, fuck that. And fuck you. Because I just noticed the other day you tried to say, what did you say? Was I still being a ham?
Yeah, you was being a ham ass nigga. But all on Facebook and your feelings.
I might be in love.
But I know you ain't talking, though. I
felt that, though. I felt that status. I felt that. Because it's like, bro, if it's good, it's good.
Definitely. Talking about the conversation I had with my grandma earlier. But my grandma is a fool.
Did you nut in her?
Nah, she ain't even. Look.
Did you pull out?
We ain't even going
to. Did you, D-Lo? Did you? I know you didn't, you sick bastard. You bastard.
Nah, man. You know, it's so warm in there. You know what I'm saying?
Yo, pussy is amazing. It feels like an apple pie.
Yeah. And there's nothing better than a apple nice, pie? Warm apple pie.
Ooh, man, give me tingles a second about this shit.
Yeah,
ooh,
like, so it's like, chat. You know, sometimes you just got to stay up in there. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, Rashe, shout out. You see, we on time this week.
Exactly, man. Listen, we pulled that. See, listen, man.
We switching shit up.
We be trying, man. We're going to get there.
But, hey, that W-I-W is...
The wood inside of a wood? I don't think the people know about the wood inside of a wood.
How that shit
is important. That is to a culture. We should have rolled one.
Just to show y'all.
Oh. I got one in my poison.
It's rolled already?
It's on the poison.
No,
we can't show the people.
Next episode, I'm going to have like three of them motherfuckers.
But listen, y'all, if y'all follow us on Snapchat, my nigga, y'all would see them wood inside of a wood. Y'all see
exactly.
This?
Exactly.
Please. Because we be off them motherfuckers. Like, we smoke those. Like,
and we be on Snapchat.
Faithfully. Quake, can you get my Snapchat name real quick?
Yeah, our Snapchat is Ignit Gang. So if you're a part of Ignit Gang, go follow us on Snapchat.
And we have shirts, crop tops, hats, all that shit.
Facts.
All that shit.
Hold on. Matter of fact, let me show y'all something.
Hold on. Go ahead.
Work it. Work it. Work it. Work it.
Oh,
work
shit.
It. Work it. Work
yes.
It. Work it.
Yes. But nah, man, listen, if you watching this shit right now, did y'all like, share, follow, all that good shit, man? Come
make
on,
sure
man,
y'all keep commenting, too. Make
exactly.
Sure y'all keep commenting.
Keep this shit. Get good content coming in, man. BLE Popular Ignorance, episode 16, man. We at BLE Studios, man.
Shout
put bullshit
out to Dave, man. He put up with us every single week. Fact. Every
man.
Single week.
Nah, for real, though. We like, after the show end, we would dead ass be outside his house, like, just smoking nonstop.
Blowing
like, 2 in the morning. And he'll never trip.
He'll just come out, y'all crazy, man.
Like, yeah, and y'all motherfuckers still out here smoking in your y'all niggas don't charged. Ever go home.
We don't want to go home. We like it over here.
Never go home.
If y'all have something that y'all would like to, you know, go live, y'all want to broadcast, y'all see this beautiful ass studio, make sure y'all hit the BLE Inc. Studios page up.
Hit them up.
Yeah, please go hit them up.
Exactly.
So
prices
you can book
is very reasonable.
Take that.
You ain't going to find no scenery, no studio. Like
not lavish
nowhere.
Like this, my nigga. Look at this shit.
Nowhere in town.
We got everybody here. Listen.
Nowhere in town.
Nowhere.
Take that.
Beautiful shit,
and it's
my
a black owned business.
Definitely.
Black owned, my man.
Independent. 100%.
100%.
So let's dive into Ignit Weekly. Now, if y'all know what Ignit Weekly is by now, my nigga, you too fucking late. Nah, I'm just fucking with you. Listen, Ignit Weekly is basically against an assortment of topics we all come together and just talk about we seen throughout the week type shit.
I'm pretty sure we all been seeing the same thing throughout the week.
Oh, yeah.
What you talking about?
We finna talk some shit this episode.
Oh, Lord.
Shit. Finna talk some shit.
Talk to me, man. What y'all got? Who want to go first?
I can start us off.
Yeah. Go ahead, Quay.
So, throughout this, I don't know if y'all have seen it. Probably, I think it was like at the ending of last week and kind of early this week. Future got put on child support.
Go
ahead. So the whole situation was, so before they went to court, Future was, he had a defamation case against the baby mama. Let's start here. Future
that boy, Dirty Dan,
has,
like that apple pie.
He has eight kids with 8 different baby mothers. We love to talk about how many babies these bitches got. But this nigga has 8 separate families that he started.
I ain't even gonna lie.
My nigga, listen, in the Bible it says. In the Bible, this
nigga right with there. With your wife.
Listen, though. Be fruitful and multiply.
Be fruitful with your wife. Nobody said be fruitful.
You bitches don't deserve the fruitfulness of the multiply.
I can get that. I didn't know he even was married. But if he was single, popping them bitches like that, nigga, you my role model because.
He's single, he's laying dick. So that's all he's doing, bro. He's enjoying life.
And popping them bitches.
No. That's
what's wrong with that, Quay? How is it wrong? It's a popping
bitch.
Because
he's missing scheduled visits with kids he already got.
Ain't nothing wrong with popping in the broke.
We talked about that, yo.
He started 8 different families. Not me. 8 different families. So 8 different kids are growing up without seeing their dad all the time. Without
kids.
And that's why we'll stay here. But anyway, like I was saying. So Eliza is the girl's name. Rain is the baby's name. So this all started back in 2019. So Eliza really didn't want as much as she was given. She was going to settle for like $500 a month, but Future didn't want her to get any type of support because he was like, well, that's not my baby. I don't feel like I should have to do that. Paternity test came back. Now he has to pay $53,000 a month in child support.
My father, that's too much, because why you need all that money?
No, it's not. It's based off of.
Before we finish, can you take this pepper spray? I got bad memories.
Okay, my bad. PTSD. My fault.
I don't want to be around that.
Because here is how.
Didn't that one bitch mace you?
Yeah, man.
Matter of fact, again, whenever we see you, we stomping you. I don't care where it's at. If he points you out, you're getting your ass beat.
Dear homies, take that.
Facts, yo.
Take that.
I don't care what I got in my trunk. You getting hit with it.
Car seats, I got a whole spare in all that shit.
A whole spare.
With a tire, nigga.
Boy, I will clear her shit.
Hit her with the donut.
Listen, fuck her ass.
I will slide that bitch.
Still, it's like that. So just know it's like that for you.
That's funny,
but.
Go ahead with your point. $53,000 is way too fucking much money.
Do you know how it's calculated?
How is it calculated?
Let Future tell it. That's just shoe money.
I mean, it is. But
I saw the post.
I definitely
that's what
the
he
point.
Said. And then he tried to call.
Fuck what's up, sir? Thank you. Respect me as such. That's all I ask of you. Go ahead.
He tried to call her ugly. He tried to say all these other things.
Hey, as much as I fuck with Future, bro, he not shit, bro.
He's not.
I never said the nigga wasn't shit. All I said was that. $53K, that's way too much money for child support.
Thing is, he made it worse on himself because he was actually supposed to originally play $400.
Listen,
but he tried to be boosy. Yeah, and that's now it. He's paying $3. So it's like, nigga,
some of you bitches, you really, listen, some of you bitches gets be in it for the kids.
Just some of y'all though.
Yeah. Just not all y'all, but some of you bitches gets be in it for the kids. So I'm not. No. How we know this bitch went in it for the kids?
That's all for the
clout. It don't matter what she was in it for. She now has a child with.
Fuck that.
She now has a child with him, and you need to take care of your part of
that
child.
Then give me the kid. Then give it to me.
Do you think Future could raise a kid by himself?
Yes.
Yeah. No, yeah, I don't know that man.
I don't know that man to say he can't raise no kid by himself.
Why you think that?
Yeah.
Because of the lifestyle he lives.
What lifestyle do he live?
A rock star lifestyle.
How is that?
What's so wrong with that?
What do you mean, what's so wrong with that?
I don't get what's so wrong with that. Like,
living a crazy lifestyle is not stability.
What's so wrong with living like Larry? I don't get it.
Because it's not stability. Kids need stability. They don't need to go on the road and travel places. Yes, that is good for summer. But that's not good for the wintertime when he needs to be in school, when they need bedtimes, they need meal regimens. They don't need to eat whatever, whenever, and do whatever.
How you know that's not happening though?
Huh?
How you know that's not happening?
I don't know it's not happening. I just don't think, based off of Future's previous actions, I don't think that sitting in a chat
previous
with
actions with bitches, though. These bitches be lying all the time. Yo, bitches be liars.
True enough. But if you don't have respect for your baby's mother, it's just, I don't know. You just gotta have, I think it's
you
just.
You heard what he said? He ain't got no manners for no slut.
Put a thumb in the
Based butt. Off of his previous actions, I just, you know, of all of the stuff that he has
he ride
going
for
on,
his niggas and lie to his bitch.
And I felt that.
Because you got to for sometime.
You dig what I'm saying? But like, yeah.
You
like,
said that the 53K was too much. Why you think so?
Because why does it take that much to raise a kid? Bitch, I'm paying for you and the kid lifestyle at this point.
Yeah. Well, I mean, now.
But he be like saying on Facebook all the time, you bitches are poor.
Not even that. So the way that he got calculated, the way that amount got calculated and how it gets calculated each time, let me break it down for y'all. So we take the mom's income, we take the dad's income, we combine those together. We then take whatever percentage of money that you're making for the non-custodial parent. So say the non-custodial parent has 60%. It's 60% of their income, and then it's the 40% of the mother's income. So it's split 60-40. So if it's $1,000, you pay $600, she pays $4.
So she's paying child support too?
Not she's paying child support too, but
so where her money going?
Yours, huh?
Where her money going?
To bills.
How you know?
I'm dead.
That 53.
Wait.
So you telling me that $53,000 he's sending her is not, what is it going to?
No, I'm not.
It should go to the child.
Just how child support is calculated. Yeah. That's what I was only speaking on. $53,000 is enough to fund her lifestyle. I completely agree with that. But when you have a child with somebody who has that amount of money, there is no reason why that child shouldn't live the same lifestyle that their parent does.
So give me the kid. Give me the kid. If he wanted to get the kid.
He didn't even believe that the kid was his at first.
That brings me to a comment Bree Jackson said. Hold on, let me go back. She says she did the fraternity test by swabbing her kid and another one of his kids to determine he was the father.
Mm-hmm.
He kept refusing to do a test.
Man, fuck them kids.
So he literally did not want to assume responsibility for the child, but since he has enough money, just go send the kid to live with him? No. I feel like your kid, yes, leave your kid here to live with me so that they can be raised in structure, and then pay me what I need, pay what needs to be paid in order for them to live the lifestyle that you live.
I made a post earlier this week. These bitches need guidance. They are raised off Rotel and Alfredo. Ain't no way in fuck I'm about to allow you to raise my kid. Give me that motherfucker. You need 53K? I'll give you that 53K. It don't be that simple sometimes. I agree with you.
Because the pussy be so fire.
After seven.
It be so fire. But then again, you got to think about it. It's like, do you really want that bitch to have your child?
After seven?
That's what I'm saying, bro.
You got to think about it. Y'all can get 100 bitches pregnant in a two-week span.
Y'all have that ability. Y'all have to choose who y'all want y'all mothers to be. And if you choose the wrong bitch, how is that my fault?
But sometimes it don't be like that. Sometimes it's just okay. There be so many politics and situations. Bitches fuck hoes and condoms.
Niggas do too.
Bitches drug niggas.
I'm that nigga. I'm the nigga.
Wait.
You put hoes in condoms, dog?
I'll be wanting to run. Hey, bitch, give me my son.
You're
this
sick.
This nigga, you be trying to trap bitches, bro?
Hold on, wait. Can they all?
Hey, you nasty nigga. You know that?
I'm upfront about it. I tell them upfront.
Like, hey, I'm trying to trap you.
No, it's just like, I'll tell them. Like, I'm going to give you a baby.
I'm going to give you a baby.
Like, you got like a time period? Like, when you going to give me the kid?
No, I just know right then and there. I'll be like, okay. I hang out with him one time. I'll be like, yeah, bitch, you can get a baby.
All right,
All it takes is for me to just look at a bitch one time. Yeah. And she fine? Oh, yeah.
And her personality bomb? Oh, yeah.
It's
bitch,
like,
I'm,
bro.
Yeah.
You niggas are sick. But nah, I ain't gonna lie, though, bro. Look, you can't keep doing that shit. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I ain't never did it, but I'm just saying.
You better than me, though, because I'm not telling the bitch nothing. She ain't gonna find out until she asks me where I nutted.
To the day up, huh?
She got, did you nut at me? Yes. What size diaper she?
Yep, I sure did.
You niggas are sick. Gonna be a boy or a girl.
I keep going like ain't shit ever happened. You did what I'm saying? Dead homies. Popping that bitch all over again. Dead homies. But she ain't gonna be.
What?
I swear to God.
Niggas are fucking sick. Yo,
be like shacking the motherfucker.
Next thing she knows, she got morning sickness.
You niggas are sick, yo.
Act like we don't. I know.
You know what?
I know when it happens.
A female knows when she's getting.
They can feel that.
I'm not gonna stop. She didn't already did it. Let's keep it going. Let's keep this motherfucker rolling.
I like the energy. Let's go to CVS tomorrow.
We're going
50-50 on this motherfucker.
Look, I ain't tripping off none of that shit, honestly. Yeah. Look, because whatever happens, happens. Look, I'm put like this.
If God gonna bless me with a kid, he gonna give me that kid.
We gonna handle whatever situation come about. Look, you do what I'm
you had two choices. You said it's either you gonna birth a child or you gonna put it in God's hands.
Listen, God, I was about to say that. You know, that's an underrated... You know, bitches that get abortions are underrated. Bitches that get abortions are underrated. They really are. Them bitches are. They push the culture forward.
What do you mean?
Because sometimes, listen, bitch, I don't want to have a baby with you. You know you was a mistake. God damn it.
I didn't mean to fuck you.
Well, that kind of goes to a comment that we have on here that said you shouldn't be nutting in bitches that you don't want to have a baby with.
Oh my God. And that's a fact.
That's
true.
That makes life not fun.
But listen,
that's fact.
I agree.
Sometimes, bro, bitches just be really.
It just it be like that, man. That shit. It's.
Oh yeah, I got you.
Like sometimes it really just. Shit, y'all heard what my grandma said earlier? Shit, if it's good, it's good.
Shit, you know, you just be
in a moment.
I felt that.
You know, you just be in a moment. But dead homie, shit, it just shit, fuck it. Look, I ain't gonna look.
That's why I said the bitches that get abortions are underrated, yo.
So, Maddie, we got a comment from Maddie Clark says, so you're not gonna tell your girl if you nutting her?
Nah, if you my girl.
If you ask.
I'm not gonna disclose the information to you.
If you don't ask or they don't react like they nutted in you, you won't know. That's why you gotta go and check yourself.
I'm gonna get in this chair and make me a sandwich.
Boy, I'm chilling. I'm rolling. Yeah, matter of fact, I fuck around. I'm about to head out and leave. Oh God! Like, nigga, I'm rolling. I'm rolling woods.
Listen, I'm about to go in your kids.
I'm finna roll woody.
Hey, I'm about to go get by this motherfucker. I got to go, bitch.
I'm finna go get a crib right now.
Look, everything is already. Look, the money's there. That's not the problem. You do what I'm saying. The money.
Baby gonna be Gucci. Don't worry about the baby.
Yeah,
the baby
that's
gonna be
Gucci. Why
I'll
be tripping. Yeah.
Like, I think
when you have a child, whoever keeps the child, like, so if it's a mother and father, if the mother keeps the child 5 days a week or 5 to 7 days a week, and the dad just, you know, gets visitations on the weekends, I think that whatever cost that. Change. So say your rent was $500, but you had to move up to a 2-bedroom, so it's now $750. That $250 that y'all have needs to be split to $125 because you need to pay the difference that your child made in my rent. Mm-hmm. If that makes sense. That's how child support is calculated.
It is.
Yeah, that's exactly how it's calculated.
Yeah, child support
don't make it right, though. That don't make it right.
Child support is based off of
income. No, it don't.
So, wait.
Just because the white man said it was right.
Exactly.
No, right.
Every law they have makes it right.
No, I didn't say that. Not every law. You jumped way far ahead.
You said child support was right. Yo, that shit not right, yo, at all.
The way that it's calculated is right. I think the way that it is calculated for the parents who should be on.
So, if a nigga got a kid or whatever. If a nigga get a bitch pregnant and he says, mm-hmm. I don't want to have this kid with you, I don't want to be a part of this kid's life.
Totally different conversation.
I'm saying
that
how?
Is definitely a different.
Totally different conversation.
That is,
how?
That's totally different conversation.
That's not a different conversation.
It is. Because we're talking
it's still
about
dealing with child support. At the end of the day, that nigga's still gonna be put on child support if you don't take care of that kid.
Right.
His life still gonna get fucked over. They're gonna take his license, his passport, he's gonna go to jail.
Why did you nut in that girl if you didn't
OG,
have a baby
OG,
with
what
her?
You gotta say?
That's your fault.
What you gotta go say, ahead. OG?
$3,000 a month. It's only $636,000. That motherfucker made $19 million in 2019.
That's chump change.
Then give me my kid.
If you are stable enough to raise a child, I will give you your child. But if you're not,
Future is stable enough to raise a child. I mean, I know he toured like a motherfucker, but
he just don't want to though.
He got other kids he probably got in the house though. Who would say that he ain't
Not saying that he's not responsible, but I'm saying whoever can be consistent in that child's life is the one who should keep them.
Man, if you work, like Russell Wilson got good hair.
Huh?
Nothing, go ahead.
What? So if me and my significant other, if me and somebody, we have a baby and I keep my child 7 days a week and they only pick them up, you know, every once in a while, or they see them, you know, every other weekend they pick my child up, I do feel like, I won't put you on child support as long as you're taking care of what you need to, but I feel like any difference that your child makes in my life, I pay half, you pay half.
Why do you say your child, though?
It's our child.
It's our child.
Exactly, but if I don't say
you laid down and bust that motherfucker open too,
exactly,
you know what I'm saying?
That's what I'm saying. You're not, you're missing, you're only hearing the your and not listening to the split. That's what I'm. You're only hear the your and you're not listening to the split. I'm saying that everything that has to do with our child should be split 50-50. Any difference that our child makes in either one of our lives should be made. If we have a birthday party, split it 50-50.
All right, so listen. If that's the case, if you had to upgrade houses, and so that I had to upgrade houses, then therefore you need to be stop, Quay. Mm-hmm. Therefore, then you need to be trying to. Well, she need to, well, not she, like just the you need to be trying to like
pay some kind of that rent, some kind of bill, a light bill,
yeah, or something. But so if that's the case,
this is what I'm saying.
If that's the case, because I got to upgrade too.
Right, I'm saying so when it only affects one person is what I'm saying.
How is it only affecting
you
though?
No, let me flip it. So say the dad keeps the child the majority of the time, right?
Right.
And he had to go from a one bedroom to a two bedroom, but the mother did not. She stayed in her one bedroom because she felt that was right. So if he has to make an upgrade in rent, she should still pay that half. I'm saying for either parent, not for.
But what parent's not gonna do that though? What parents don't stay in a one bedroom and let their kids live in that one bedroom with them for their entire fucking life?
Men do it. Men do it.
Some men do that shit.
And or they don't live with their parents, or they live with their parents. Or they live with their parents, or they live with somebody else, so they can't keep their kids.
I know some niggas personally. That's why I'm saying, like,
are they struggling though?
Not necessarily.
I don't know exactly.
By the looks of it.
You can't say
outside. On the outside looking in, did it look like struggle?
But some people are not struggling. They're just comfortable with their.
So they had no choice but to live in that one bedroom.
No.
He got $53K to give to her. So that means he got $53K to live into another, move into another house, right?
Well, see, now you're talking about a whole different tax bracket now.
Yeah, I'm talking about just regular people.
Shit changed when you get. We're not talking about even them.
We're talking about future and
we're talking about child support specifically.
Yeah, we're talking about that child specifically. Yeah. No, we ain't talking about
My bad.
Because it's like you said, he made $19 million last year.
Right.
At first, Future only wanted to give her $450 a month.
Quay was just saying that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's kind of just how I started it off. No, you're fine. But that it's just whoever is the main parent, they need that additional whatever. They need whatever additional comes with the child has to be split. So if the father is the one taking care of the kid, the mother needs to be the person who plays that other half.
On top of her own bills.
The problem is,
but I just don't feel
it's
like
it's not just rent. I'm saying
she's
anything.
Building wealth though at this point, $53,000 a month. Yeah, she's that, building wealth.
Way more than four kids. Facts.
Yeah.
So it ain't even about her.
That's like six. That's $60,000 a year.
But her. But
all of us grew up on struggle type shit. I mean, not struggle type shit, but we know struggle.
Yeah.
You think what I'm saying?
Definitely the struggle. Definitely.
We done seen her mama's feed motherfuckers off $20.
Yeah.
Bitch, what the fuck do you need $53K for?
For her son to live the lifestyle that Future's other kids live?
Give me my kid.
You said, what does he need it for? Not give me my kid. What does he need it for? So that her child, child can live the same lifestyle that the rest of Future's kids live.
And that's why he's saying, like, give me my child then, like,
cause he can still get that lifestyle over here
if he wants his child.
Yeah. It could be like Boosie. That nigga, all his kids live with him.
Exactly. So like,
that's how I'm talking.
So all of his kids benefit from his lifestyle. He doesn't need to be put on child support because all of his children benefit from his lifestyle. Future did not want that child to benefit from his lifestyle, so now he has to let that child benefit from his lifestyle.
Right. I think so. I think he didn't want to because he didn't know if the baby was his or not.
Nor did he want to find out.
That's true.
So if he's talking about future specific situation, he didn't want that motherfucker.
Okay, think about it. Okay, if he was
we got seven right here. We got seven, so it's just like we got seven.
Think about it in Jay-Z shoes. You know how many? Yeah. Okay, once a year, a bitch comes out and say, "Oh, Jay-Z had I have Jay-Z's son," type shit.
Uh huh.
Jay-Z be like, "Oh my god, again! I got to go get another child support. Oh my god, another paternity test. Like fuck, like." You know what I'm saying? Bitches gonna come out and say that shit. So he probably just wasn't getting around to doing this shit because he thought the bitch was against on some weird shit trying to get some money.
Yeah, like he probably know he fucked her with a condom and all type of extra shit. Mm-hmm. So you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's like, but at the same time,
I put the gym in your extra time.
I still feel like you should want to find out if the baby yours though.
That's
like,
true.
Like I said,
if
bro,
you
Future
love
ain't
your kid,
shit, bro, that's my nigga. But he ain't shit, bro.
Never gonna be shit.
Like, if you love your kid or you love children and you love, you know,
but if you just a real nigga, period, bro. Like, how you gonna just have a baby? Yeah, bro. Look. And me and Lionel was having this talk on the phone yesterday. Like, niggas who don't take care of their kids. Of course, yeah. That's my boy. That's my boy. We was on the phone for like 2 hours yesterday. just talking about everything.
Go ahead.
And we were just like, nigga, that nigga line up told me, he's like, I can't shake hands with niggas who don't take care of their kids.
Yeah, not at all.
And I felt that. Me and niggas who don't take care of their kids, but we are not cool.
Like, we can't be. What, we what can't we? Be.
Because how can homes. I respect you? Like, I can't respect that.
Exactly.
Because you don't take don't your responsibility
come, don't
serious.
Even come around here. Don't.
I know a lot of niggas that's.
If you do your kid dirty, how do I expect you not to do me?
How you gonna be more loyal to me?
That's like, your child.
Own flesh and blood.
Exactly.
Like, I know niggas
that be like that don't
you gotta
work.
Comment.
I know niggas that work that don't got no hustle no nothing. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And still like be there for their kids. Like exactly. Not even financially, but just like
them niggas are struggling, but they still do whatever they. Shit, I did it. I was struggling, but I was there for a kid that wasn't even mine.
Taking care of that white baby.
Exactly. Man, come on, man. Let's keep it moving to the next topic, man. Fuck all the bullshit.
Question, how you got the bitch mace? That was my ignorant weekly.
That's your ignorant weekly?
Yeah,
that's
my
ignorant weekly. How did you let the bitch mace you? That's
okay, my story, bro.
My
okay, so we got it. We got it. It was an argument, bro. So and like, I don't know why she tried to
say.
Like she was the type of person. She, I'm the type of person that's like, I'm not gonna let you punk me. Like I don't give a fuck who you are. I'm not scared of nobody. I have no fear. Nobody puts fear in my heart. I am not scared of death or anything. None of that. So she was talking shit to me, you know, and she calling me the N-word and whoop de whoop and all this shit.
Yeah, they
should have made a marker.
See, so, but this the thing.
I'm
like y'all know this. I am the most composed nigga ever, and like it's just. But that bitch, I was talking shit to her.
You gotta be the most composed
nigga. I was talking shit to her. But I was stating facts, but I was just saying it like just I was talking shit and I was
calm. Very monotone.
So she got mad about it, and she was
real.
Like
I don't even give a fuck.
She was trying to kick me out of my own shit. I'm like, bitch, you got me fucked up. I was like, I'm not going nowhere. She's like, if you don't leave, I'll miss your ass.
Well,
oh well. You should have rock bottom.
And I ate that. I ate that shit. The shit is so. It was so funny because like she did it and got pissed and maced herself. Bitch went in the bathroom, had a seizure. I was fucking weak.
Goofy bitch.
I would have left her down there.
Man, D-Lo, go ahead and slide to your Ignorant Weekly right quick, G.
No, that was his Ignorant Weekly.
The bitch. Okay, got you, the bitch.
I'll actually read some comments.
Go ahead.
LaToya Rudd, our top fan, she got her Popular Ignorant shirt.
I do got three
shirt.
Sisters.
I know y'all seen that, so make sure y'all go and tap in and go buy a Popular Ignorant shirt if y'all want to support us. She said, he don't want that baby.
We don't know that, LaToya.
She said Russell Wilson got good hair. I'm yeah, like, it's fuck. You know he got that light skin, curly, Corbin blue Russell type.
I'm light skin. My shit ain't good at all. What you talking about?
That bullshit. He be, but that nigga is such a.
Hey, I got natural hair.
No, a cornball.
Is a pure.
Von Shea says she says my daughter all the time, so she claims her. Like I say, like if I'm talking about my mama to my sister, I'm like, go get your mama. Like, just, you know, not saying it like...
I get your point.
Yeah, not saying it like, that's really your mama. Just your mama. It's my mama, too.
Look, I wish a bitch would. Your daughter. Yeah, all right, bet.
Bet you don't see her no more.
All right, how about it then?
Ron Shea said, what the fuck does Russell have to do with Future being a piss poor father?
Who said that? It was a joke. It was just a joke.
Yeah. It was a joke.
Relax. Let me see here. It says that's one kid he absolutely did not want, and it's painfully clear she had to get the test through other methods because he didn't want to claim it at all. It's a lot of knees out today. Yeah, I see us.
You know that is?
It's the D's knees.
No, man. Demetrius. The world's smallest
Demetrius body. Demetrius is out here. Homies, why that sad shit they talking about in the goddamn comment?
Because Russell Wilson and he didn't want the baby.
On the world's smallest violin. That shit is funny.
That's my favorite. How do you say it?
Oh, my God.
Gif?
How are you supposed to say it?
Gif? Tomato, tomato, my nigga. Same difference at this point.
Yeah.
Well, my ignorant weekly is, bro. So, listen. I've been getting into with bitches all week because I...
Okay. Oh, shit.
I've been talking about this. I know I've been talking about this last few episodes, but... Get my ass ate. It's been like a reoccurring topic throughout my life.
Nah, dead homies. I ain't gonna fake. Like,
listen.
So my inbox been going crazy. Like, ever
was
since.
Was ass
like,
cop?
Yeah, for top, like 2 weeks.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Why was that dude or female on y'all ass?
So pissy with me? About me getting my ass ate? Yo, I really don't know. Like, okay, so basically it was a whole, like
you're a whole
status
stud.
Got shared.
And it was a stud.
You're a whole stud.
Like, a status got posted that said, if you get your ass ate, you're sweet. So me being the nigga I am, I seen this shit like, Let's do this. So I was like, I shared this shit. Was like, the fact that a stud said this is hilarious.
Yeah, that is.
Like, how are you calling something gay?
Yeah, because you know of all things gay, right?
Nigga, like. Nigga.
Like those touch me not studs, they be like, oh, don't touch me, that's gay, like, girl. Let she, me touch that pussy.
It. Exactly. Let me touch that pussy. Shut up.
It, it had to experience that, and now it's confused if it wanted to sit or stand up.
Am I the only one who, like, just, like, low-key thinks stud coochie stink? Probably. I've been thinking the same thing. Only one who think that? You know what I'm saying?
I ain't even gonna lie. I never really thought about it.
If you a stud and your coochie don't stink, comment right now.
Every time I'm out somewhere, it don't matter where I'm at, bro. If I see a dyke, nigga, I'm going to think her coochie stink, bro.
Hey, man, if you know what's up, the coochie don't stink, share this. Like, share, comment, man. It's popping in this episode 16, man.
We had 20 hours.
Share this motherfucker.
But nah, okay, but really, we on good bullshit.
Go ahead.
All studs booty stink. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I can't watch that motherfucker.
Dookie in your booty, bitch.
Dookie. Booty ass.
Dookie booty, bitch. But nah, okay, my question is this.
Is getting your ass ate gay?
No, so. The fuck?
I never.
And if it is,
I'm not going to talk about this
because somebody play devil's advocate on this shit real quick.
I'm going to put it like this. Nigga, nothing is.
That's
nothing
the shit
is
that
would
fuck with.
Whoa! Stop. If nigga getting pegged, that's gay, bro.
Come on, wait, let him talk.
He's talking,
let
bro.
Him talk.
Like,
go
damn.
Relax. Talk your shit. I'm sorry.
I feel like. Damn. Excuse me. I feel like anytime you, if you do any sexual act with another man, like that's gay. You know what I'm saying? Or if you let a bitch peg you, that is like.
Yeah.
That's
my whole point.
But, thank you. Yeah. But I feel like, bro, if you get your ass ate by a bitch, you know what I'm saying? Like
a bitch.
How
I don't think there's
gay?
Anything that
what
you
stick a finger in the shoe.
Nah, I'm not.
That's gay.
That's doing too much, bro. You're doing too much.
No utensils in the salad, please.
I don't,
be respectful.
I don't think that is gay, because anything that you do with a woman, anything that you do, if it's a man and a man, is what makes it gay. If it's a woman, it's a woman. That's what makes it lesbian. If it's a man and a woman, I mean a man.
But if you're getting, if you letting that bitch fuck you, bro, you're gay. Yeah. because it's the concept of being fucked by a nigga.
Yeah.
You're
any
gay,
concept
like,
of being fucked by a nigga, but if you fuck your bitch in the shoe. Or if you lick your butt, then that's just what you like. I mean, should you bring it up during dinner? No, keep that shit to yourself.
I am talking this,
but you know,
I never experienced.
I'm bringing
it
that shit up. Well,
I tell you, never got your ass ate.
Nope.
Okay, is everybody on the panel got their ass ate?
I'm not for the butt stuff, man.
For sure,
I'm not for the butt. Look, listen.
If you are a man out there and you got you a girl that you really fuck with and you want to show her you really fuck with her, stick your tongue in
her
butt.
See, I am not opposed to doing it to, like, my significant other.
Yeah.
Her doing it. Nah, I ain't wrong with that.
Why, bro?
What if she just, like, lick that motherfucker wrong and just...
No, no.
Why?
Yeah, she do that motherfucker. Zip. I'm like, hold on, bitch.
No, trust me.
What are you doing?
I bet
you're not going to do that.
I would be like, what are you doing?
I bet your little dick going to do
that. I want to know why, nigga. I want to know why, Montel.
Bro, no.
Why?
No.
Why?
No.
You say no until she do it.
You can't even give me no real answer.
No, because.
But why?
It's just, it don't seem right. It just don't seem right.
It feels right, though. Trust me.
This shit feels amazing.
Hold on, wait.
Oh,
we got
God.
Some comments. You know,
I know why, though. It's
why. Shit that will fuck with your brain. Boy.
Yeah.
Why?
He don't need nothing fucking with his
y'all
brain.
Y'all see how the shit had me acting. You know what I'm saying?
Look.
That nigga D-Lo went right for about 3 weeks. He was like, man, listen. I don't think I'm about to settle down, man.
I said settle down.
Damn, settle?
What?
Who are you? Where's your reset button?
Oh, God, man. I've been cloned.
I don't like my ass being played with like that.
It's not being played with.
I don't care. I don't care. I just don't want nothing touching my ass.
You ever
ass.
Take a wet wipe?
Nigga,
it just rubs
it
across
the same.
It's the same
it's
shit,
not even
man.
The same. It's better to me. Like that shit.
Because it got a little pressure behind it.
Bro, it's it literally feels like, man, she's eating your hole, bro.
Oh,
like,
shit.
You ever like brush your teeth and they like draw like some really cold water?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, right?
That's what it feels like. It's like the minty
it's
refreshingness.
Like it's like when you're outside hooping. And you drink some water, like you feel it go down all the way.
Oh, your
that's
chest.
Like, that's what getting your ass, like, bro.
It gets, oh, man.
Wait.
Go ahead.
Just think about a time where you, like, just absolutely got your meat blobbed, like, not, like socks Ooh. Knocked off. Like,
you ain't never got your gooch lick?
No.
Suck nothing?
No.
Damn.
But you are not living.
I had some.
Have you ever had head that made you come?
No. That's it. God. That shit's a myth.
That shit is a myth.
It's not a myth, bro.
It's a myth.
If you are throat goat, hit him. Now.
Hit my mans, bro.
Hit him now.
Please bless him.
Get my niggas right, man. Please.
Please bless him.
Because he missed
send me
out.
To the y'all upper don't
know,
like,
them are the most intense nuts you gonna get.
Hey, listen.
Like, you know how, like, listen. Hey. Hold up. You know how, like, when you fucking a bitch.
The day I get that, she's
getting pregnant. Listen, you know how when you're fucking a bitch, right? And you know how, like, the nut you get from fucking a bitch? Bro, that don't even compare to like when you about to pop in a bitch mouth, bro. Like, bro, that shit don't even compare.
Yeah, preach, preacher.
It's like, think about the build up, bro. The build up.
That's the best part about
boy. Like,
Latoya, it is sad. I'm sorry.
When it finally comes, bro, it's just like, boy.
None of the females I've been with didn't have it like that.
Especially if you just drop that motherfucker to the back of your neck. Niggas go
crazy. Bro, like, when you about to pop and she just starts sucking your shit so slow.
Nigga yodeling. Oh, bitch. Oh.
Yodeling.
I sound like Lucci, that motherfucker.
Chat.
Let me read some of these comments. So,
I just can't believe this nigga.
I thought so at first. It's something in your ass, but I guess not. It's not. It's just the hole.
I guess my hole.
Amina said, I thought so at first because it's something in your ass, but I guess not. It's not in your ass. It's on your ass.
Nah, you sick of tongue. That's something. Nah, that tongue in that motherfucker.
It's definitely
in that motherfucker.
It's definitely up in that.
I guess I'm missing out because everybody talking about throat goats and shit, and I ain't never experienced it.
Let me see what the throat goats had in the comments.
So, Bree Jackson said you want a tongue in your ass, but not an object. Yep. Yeah, because objects hurt.
I don't want no
I'll take a
in my
thumb,
ass.
But dick in your butt. Bro, Shay
said your sex like boring as fucking night, and I have to second that notion.
Yeah. I would say that I agree.
Sex life is
I agree.
It's vanilla.
I mean, I still haven't had my threesome. But other than
it
says Bree Jackson. I mean, Latoya Rudd said it's not the inside; they just want a rim job.
Yeah. No. That's not what I'm saying. Stick your entire tongue in my ass.
Dude, let me finish with the fucking comment.
Not for real though.
What?
So please, and then Bree Jackson says, "LOL." So you're familiar with the procedure, Bree Jackson. I mean, yeah. Who was that, Latoya? You know what you're doing.
Latoya, not look ass.
She said, hashtag mission.
You dig what I'm
mission,
saying?
Get Montel ass eight.
Montel, listen, I know somebody. You know what?
Listen, we
not. Hold on.
Before I get my ass eight,
oh God.
I need a bitch to make me come sucking my dick.
I need a bitch that's gonna make me come eating my ass, bro.
Listen, you know, no, wait. I'm gonna tell y'all what I need. What? I need a bitch to lick my ass while I'm getting my dick sucked.
What? Listen.
How's that possible?
You need two bitches.
I can't really demonstrate right now.
You need two bitches.
I'm gonna get one.
And just stand like this.
Like goddamn Captain
Morgan. This nigga was found
one right here, one right here.
Demonstrating shit.
With the knee up, you dig?
Oh my God. And the Captain Morgan pose.
I'm gonna grab that bitch head. I'm gonna be like the peanut butter and the jelly, nigga.
Yeah. Bro, you gonna cry, bro.
I just might.
You gonna cry.
I just might. Cause that shit sound lit.
I remember like being young, hanging around like all the older niggas from the neighborhood that was already like going to Ruskin and shit. Like they was already going to Ruskin and shit. We still going to Smithdale and shit at the time.
Right.
Nigga, I must have heard about this one bitch at Ruskin sucking some nigga dick so good that he started crying.
Nigga, I've heard stories like that.
And that's what I need, bro. Like that's what I need right now.
Tears.
Shat.
Tears.
Nigga, so okay. You ever busted two nuts?
Oh, nigga, I had a girl make me pop three times.
Nigga.
Matter of fact, nigga, and that shit, I ain't never popped back to back ever again in my life, bro. Nigga, do y'all not know I still love that bitch, bro?
Nigga. Because it's like, bitch, where you going? I can't let you go nowhere. I can't.
I feel like B when he told me about the bitch who ate his ass.
You know, that nigga
said, bro, I can't give her up, bro. Like, never. I'm like, I'm sitting there looking, y'all know me, I'm trying to play him like a burger. I'm like, you better free the bitch. That's what I told you. You better free that bitch. He's like, I can't, bro. I can't.
We got any more ignorant
weeklies?
And I
feel them. Now I know.
Nah. I do got an ignorant weekly.
Go ahead. Speak your piece.
Did we talk about parents getting higher on their kids?
Nope. We talking about that later in the show.
That's
just
later.
Wait.
Okay.
You just wait. You wait.
All right.
You just
wait.
You just wait. Because I'm on all you unfit ass bitches' heads. On Jesus Christ, I am.
We gonna wait for that. I didn't really like get into the comments because once I got to the post, it was already like 48 of them.
Yeah.
I seen that. I read a couple of them. I was like, damn, they really on Quay's ass.
Yeah, they on my ass, but you bitches still on.
But that's because a lot of bitches out there are like low key crackheads.
Crackheads.
It ain't got nothing to do with their kids. kids, baby. It's bitches who don't got kids. That's like, bro, I had a bitch steal from me, bro. Steal some weed from me, bro. You know,
he shot her in the titty.
Can you tell me the story? That's some crackhead shit.
He said he shot her in the titty.
Hold on, I want to hear the story, y'all. I want to hear the story.
Mind you, it's like 2 in the morning, bro. A young nigga is knocked the fuck out, nigga. Kush coma, bro. You know what I'm saying? Bitch called me talking about some, what she say? She said some burger shit like, I want you or I miss you or
some burger shit.
Some nut ass shit like that. Me.
Meaning she wanted to suck some dick.
And you know me, I'm like, shit.
Never gonna deny that from a bitch. Never.
It's 2 in the morning, bro.
Your dick is already hard.
You know as soon as you wake up, come over here.
Girl, shut up.
Come on. I'm like, come over here. The bitch get there. Nigga, I had a blount rolled up already. Like, nigga.
A what?
A blount.
A what?
A blount.
A
blount.
What? I had a blount rolled up already. You know what I'm saying? I must have tapped that motherfucker a couple of times. That motherfucker had broke me down already. You know what I'm saying? Top notch pressure. You know what I'm saying? So then, bitch, get there. Pressure. When bitch walked through the door, like, nigga, I'm still.
Bitch.
I wake up, nigga. I let bitch in, then I go get back in the bed. Next thing I know, all I hear is bitch talking about some. Can I spark this or some shit like that? So I'm thinking bitch probably came with her own bud like she normally do. You know what I'm saying? Blunt already rolled or whatever. Actually, can she spark it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, spark that motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? I'm
do your thing. Make yourself comfortable.
Please. Because I'm comfortable.
You know what I'm saying? You know how when you up, you know what I'm saying? Like shit. Once you wake up, like you already up. So I just woke up at that point.
It's laying there type shit.
Nigga, I wake up, bro. I look at my ashtray, boy. My blount is gone. And then my jar is gone. So then it's like. I look out the door, like my living room light and shit was on, whatever. So that's where the bitch was. I get out there, I hear my jar like opening, but I heard it close.
Yeah. So I heard the.
Y'all know how jars sound when they open up.
Yeah, I heard it. And mind you, bro, I'm in and out this jar all day, every day.
Right.
I know what it sounds like when it's like, come on now, bro. I didn't know how much bud was in there, bro.
Facts.
It was exactly 10 grams of weed in that jar.
So if it's a gram more or a gram less, bitch, I'm aware.
Exactly. I'm aware. Bro,
I can eyeball that shit, nigga, bitch.
I weighed that shit up, boy. It was 9
G's.
I can look at the in my shit. Bitch stole a gram. You stole a gram.
A G, bitch. If you gonna steal, I'm gonna steal 5 of them, bitches.
Bro,
you
come on now,
steal
bro.
It.
All of it.
At least
bitch,
get high, bitch.
No, fuck that. Cause, bitch, for one, if I let you come over my house, bitch, don't steal from me, bitch. Cause you liable to catch a bullet in a titty.
Don't steal at all.
If you wanted to smoke that bad, bitch, you could have just said something. I would have rolled up. It's not that serious.
What do we call it? What do we call it? The wood inside of a wood? What do we call it?
A double wood.
W-I-W.
W-I-W. Like, bro.
You got to say it like that. Wow.
It's wild.
Bro, bitch, low-key,
wood inside of wood.
It's
our first popular ignorance topic. Or do you want to read some comments first?
No, I'm not a parent. I can't judge a parent because I'm not there yet. Incorrect, because people who work for South Church.
Wait, hold on. I see the tip of your eyes.
Relax.
Wait for it.
We're going to get that shit
talking. Because I'm tired of that comment.
Slide to the first one.
Okay, we're going to slide it to the first one. This first one is actually from Bree Jackson. We see you in here.
Hey, did she get some free merch?
Yeah,
we sent it out.
She's getting some on the way.
Okay, now what about Lene? Lene was supposed to get some.
Hey, look,
we'll talk about that afterwards.
Listen, all y'all got to do is just message
these,
me.
Now these are top fans. Now,
yeah, like
these are top fans.
Senya, y'all message me. Y'all
like these are motherfuckers who've been tapping into the podcast.
Y'all want to have
the first episode.
And comment, always.
Yeah, comment, share, oh, it's just the very first episode, so yeah.
We'll be sure to get y'all stuff out there.
Y'all getting y'all shit. That's coming.
Uh-huh.
Let's get some funk in the comments.
It's some funk.
Let's go to
don't
it.
Worry about, don't get to that. We'll read that shit afterwards.
Read it
I just
afterwards.
Want to let y'all know it's funk in the comments. Guys, y'all be good out there.
You saved them comments.
Hey, y'all be good in them comments, okay?
Should we, since we already talking about it, should we just...
might as well read it.
Might as well read it.
What's going on in the comments?
Okay,
that's our ignorant weekly right there.
No, not even that. That's where we're going. We have popular ignorance. So we have Bree Jackson. We'll come back to your popular ignorance. We didn't forget about you, but we're going to go over to Ron Shay's comment. Ron Shay's comment was, why do, because no, I made it more generic for her because I didn't want to say parents. Generic. I'm talking about anybody who's watching a child. Why do people think it is okay to be intoxicated around the children that they are watching? Please let me define intoxicated
for you. Slash
high. Intoxicated. No, intoxicated doesn't have to mean drunk. That's inebriated. Please know y'all definition. Intoxicated means of alcohol or drug because someone... That can cause someone to lose control of their faculties or behavior. When you are
nigga definition fucked up.
When you are high, I do not care what you're trying. I'm not saying that you're a completely different person when you're high, but when you are high, you are less vigilant. So if you are watching a child, why would you want to be high? yes, I'm not saying don't ever be high around kids, but if you are supposed to be the one watching this child, you need to be completely sober. Excuse because me. If anything happens to that child, it's going to fall back on the fact that you was high regardless.
I have to disagree with you just because simply on the fact that when I'm high, I feel like I'm a lot more on my P's and Q's.
You feel that
being
way.
Being drunk,
you, yeah. feel but that me, way.
No, the door is locked. I know where the kids are. I'm wondering if they check on the kids every 5 minutes. Kids Gucci? Because I'm just moving around. I'm a little paranoid.
I understand that.
But as far as me being drunk, definitely, like, I definitely feel what you're saying. But being high, I'm definitely not vibing with you. But if you're smoking some meth and snoring some coke, definitely, yeah.
Any
but
drug smoking weed, that you how? Take changes. It changes. It changes. Don't say that. Don't. It changes how you look at things.
Trying to save my
tail, bro. Goddamn meth head. Go ahead.
Go ahead. Look, look. But, hey.
I smoke shit. Rocks. Go ahead, nigga.
Hey, go ahead.
Nah, fuck that. I want to hear it.
Listen. Okay.
Go ahead, man.
You better start trying to defend that white bitch.
If he say some weird shit, bro, I'm going to stop off this nigga, bro.
You say anything positive about that white bitch, bro.
I'm piecing this shit.
Just get off the show. Just go home.
Sick nigga. I'm piecing this shit.
I experienced a lot of shit with that bitch, so that's why I must my shit.
So if y'all could answer that question for me, why do you feel okay to be intoxicated around?
So her being high on meth, how did she interact with her kids, like, after she was high?
She didn't interact with him at all. Like, she didn't have custody of the first one. And the second one, I always had her. And then I was not going to talk about her being high. I was talking about, I was going to talk about me
ahead.
Being
high. Go ahead.
I do not agree with it. Do not be, don't, any, if you're fucked up around your kid, that's, no.
It's wrong.
That's wrong.
It's you can't
wrong. Do it. If you're going to get fucked up, either have a babysitter or do it when that kid is asleep. That's
how I'm on two different spectrums of highness.
No, high is
no, high.
No, high.
Fucked up.
It don't high.
Hold on, wait, one time.
Listen. If you're doing any type of drug or any type of drinking, you're gonna even if you have a high tolerance, you're still gonna feel. you're still gonna feel it.
When they pull you over for DUI. They don't be like, oh, are you a little high? Are you crack high? Yeah. They say you're high.
You always going off the white man.
No, matter of fact, if we don't go by the white man's definition, you boozy as fuck. I'm going to tell you why. Because when they pull you up, you have to have a certain alcohol level before you get to go to jail.
And
if you had like two,
high.
Three beers,
you can have.
But if you had like two, three beers, you Gucci. If I'd had two blunts, I'm still on my shit.
I know for sure. Nope. I know me personally, nope. I ain't never did no drug other than weed.
You know nope.
Weed and liquor.
Nope.
That's it.
I'm gonna tell you that now. If you high on weed, if you go ahead.
I'm just saying, like, I know me personally, like, I ain't never did no other drug other than mm-hmm. some top notch pressure. You know what I'm saying? I can't even say high as high, because it'd be times like, okay, I'm high, but you know, I'm cool. You know what I'm saying? There's other times like, nah, I'm smacked. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like I'm pretty fucking smacked. And it's like, Say for example, in all the time I was watching, last time I watched my nephew.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, I was smacked. You know what I'm saying? I was off the woods. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But my nephew was with. He was right. He was in my arms the whole time. I wasn't smoking with him, of course. Mm-hmm. But I'm talking mm-hmm. about me while I was high, like while I was off the gas.
It already
like,
happened, and he came in the
house.
I'm
talking about making bottles, like diapers, all that type of shit. Like, and my nephew, 4 months. He 4 months old.
Mm-hmm. You have to watch him.
I think it comes to the fact that if you're, I'm thinking about it as more as like if you're doing it around them or like doing it in front of them.
That's a whole different.
Yeah. But if it's like you're already getting fucked, like if you're smoking weed and you just got done and you got to take care of a kid, just make
that's
sure
nothing,
you just
bro.
Make
like,
just
that shit ain't
yeah
nothing.
It's
I mean,
really
some people
but,
some people do abuse like the weed though, some people don't,
but it also
not everybody acts like how we
everybody's
act
high is
yeah,
different
I,
everybody's
yeah.
high is different
strokes for different folks.
Like when I was on the shit,
nigga, say on the shit. All your shit, man.
When I was on the dope, it was so bad, I was doing it in front of the baby while I was holding.
And that's a problem.
And it was like,
we don't need
the thing was, it was like, I would put, like, being on that type of, being on that drug, it makes you more aware. Like, different drugs have different effects. Being on meth, it makes you aware. Like, you're focused. Like, I would put the baby asleep, then go clean the whole fucking apartment. Mm-hmm. For no fucking reason. Be up for 3 days straight, just... I'm doing the same shit. Putting the baby to sleep and then going to
then going to
I got a question for that meth shit. I'm gonna come back.
I got a quiz for that meth shit.
For that methy ass.
I don't know.
For that ass.
Nah, but that nigga Dave Wild for that shit. Okay, LaToya Russ, answer me this. What's the difference between popping the volume prescribed for the. I'm dyslexic. I'm sorry, guys.
You good, you good, you good, you
good. Good job, Floyd.
Fuck, I'm dyslexic. Fuck you.
That nigga said, because ever since the pandemic.
What's the difference between popping the Valium prescribed to the white moms for anxiety and smoking a blunt? You're not when they give you that Valium. Give me this. When they give you that Valium, what do they tell you to do? What do they tell you not to do?
Don't operate heavy machinery. That's about it.
They say don't operate heavy machinery.
Don't drink alcohol.
And there's other, of course. And you know when you take that drug,
but they don't say nothing about the kids though.
They can't legally say anything about a child.
I mean, they should. They really they ain't got.
They can't. Anything. They can't.
So legal. Oh, okay.
So,
but in my mind, where that goes to, when you say that, that means legally you shouldn't be able to tell me shit about my kids.
But the
no,
thing,
it's not. Yeah, no, not that. Not that.
How come?
Because
how's 80 different than
you? No, because
said?
A doctor. I'm saying when a doctor prescribes you something, they prescribe it and they tell you not to do something. They don't say, don't do anything that's gonna affect. That they don't say don't do it in front of your kids because their kids are not your patient or not their patients. So the doctor can't speak on what the mother does in that instance.
We're not talking about the doctor right now. We're talking about people gets morals right now.
No, but I was talking about the doctor.
Here's the thing.
Because we were talking about being prescribed volume.
But we're not talking about, okay, but we are still prescribed to people. You dig what I'm saying? So they're not going to say, true. Hey, don't smoke around your kids. You're supposed to enably know that type shit.
Yeah, that's
I'm
something you morally, should know.
But if you still pop them pills and still around your kids, how is that any different than smoking a blunt?
I'm not saying it's any different. Kids? It's not any different.
I'm gonna
keep it a bit.
I'm gonna be high around my kids. I ain't gonna.
And I'm not
to
saying
you,
it's any
like,
different.
Like, but the I ain't gonna be smoking around them and shit. But I'm gonna be high around them.
I
for
think
sure,
that
for sure.
Being high
I'm
be around
my kids, I'm gonna be around my kids. I'm gonna be around my kids a lot. Like, period. Like,
yeah.
Just overall, and I'm definitely gonna. I'm gonna go get in my car. I'm rolling big boy woods. I'm coming back in there and chilling with my kids.
That's WIW. When you
wood inside the wood.
You're less vigilant. I feel that way honestly.
But
I feel that way honestly based off of how the brain works. Not based off and based off of past experiences with children. It's just you are a little less vigilant when you are high. I'm not saying you're a terrible person or you're unfit to be a parent or you're unfit to be around child. You are less vigilant and you should. I know because somebody shared my post and said it actually allows me to be a lot more childish when I'm with my kids. Sometimes
I did see Vernon say that shit.
Vernon said that and another girl said that. So it's like it allows me to be a little bit more childish with my kids, which I never heard anything like that. I never knew that
that's
people
real,
needed,
I do
you know,
like the hot lava game with the kids.
You know, I never knew that. People, you know, used it to, you know, bring they.
You know, when you high, like you can just get into like anything. You know what I'm saying? Like
shit,
you can see anything on TV, and it's gonna seem interesting.
But you
like,
got, you gotta also.
So that's just what that is, right there.
Yeah.
Like.
See, I didn't know that. So So let me clarify what I'm saying. I wasn't calling anybody unfit. It was weird and outside of my norm for anybody to be consistently under the influence of any type of drug or alcohol when they're in the presence of children.
I'll say this much. My our OGs, like my everybody in my family and shit, like my pops was that nigga was he drank every day. You know what I'm saying? He smoked weed every day. You know what I'm saying? And I was with my pops every day and he never used to like nod off and it was none of that. Like,
so that kind of brings me to my second question.
I was gonna disagree with you. I never seen my pop smoke weed. I never ever seen my pop smoke weed, but I knew when he was high.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But I never knew he smoked weed type shit. I never seen him roll it up. I never seen the bag, but I knew when he was like chilling type shit, like in his zone.
I was just gonna say one thing. Like I said, every drug is different. Like every drug gives you a different high. Weed is more like a stimulant. Like it depending on what type of strain you like. If it's indica or sativa, it'll give you a different feeling.
Right.
Like if it's a different drug, it's gonna affect you differently.
Right.
Like me when I first got with my ex and shit, and she before she had the baby, I went. Probably like 4 or 5 months straight off of weed.
Mm-hmm.
Like it just didn't, cause I was more focused on wanting to be more aware. But then after shit started going on and all this and that,
you want
started
to
getting into
aware.
Started getting into the shit that she was in because it was like I had to cope with her shit.
Right.
So it was just like it was a different high, and it was like, but
you know, I was aware, but the effects of it was different because it was like I said, I'll be up for like 3 fucking days, man, but then I'll just like crash. And like them days that I would crash, it seems to always happen. Like the fucking, like for me personally, if I was to have a kid, I would that would be the day I'll stop doing any type of drug, smoking, drinking, doing all that. Just for the simple fact, I'm gonna share this story. I ain't never told anybody this story, but Thanksgiving Day. Came home. This past, last year's Thanksgiving. I came home high off of the shit. I was off of the dope. Okay. I didn't shoot it. I was high off of it, right? So, and I left.
Even think about it. I left,
and we was driving home. Next thing you know, I dozed off at the wheel. Almost crashed the car. Mm. But thank God, I just ended up on the side. And I ended up getting in the passenger seat, and she drove the rest of the way home.
Yeah.
And that was like...
Hold on, wait. This bitch was in the car while you drove?
Mm-hmm. She was like... I thank God you back home.
They was both gone as fuck.
But we was both doing it at the same time. Yo, doing it damn near every... I did it every day for like a month and a half straight.
It's another topic for another day?
Yeah. But
I dare homies. You never get a bitch like that again. I'm beating you in that bitch up.
We do got some comments down here. So Romel said, when you drunk or high, your mind is in... Romello? Not Romel, sorry.
That's my dog, too.
Romello said, when you're high or drunk, your mind is in a different state. Latoya Russ said, my tail funny as fuck. Ronche said, a weed is a drug no matter how you try to flip it. I do agree with that. I don't believe as strong as other drugs that are out there, but it still does fall under that category. It says, my daughter has never seen me smoke. Have she been around me at family gatherings? Slipping? Yes. Call the state on me. Why would I call the state on you? You're not an unfit.
Listen. Hold on.
You're not an unfit. I'm going to speak to this.
Talk your shit.
You're not, like I just told you and everybody else, you're not an unfit parent for being drunk or high. I'm not saying that. What I'm saying, you are less vigilant. And it can make you, you know, it can force you into situations. It can force you into situations where you have to.
No charger.
Where you needed to be paying attention to your child, but you weren't because you are now under the influence of a drug or an alcohol. I'm not saying you're a bad parent, and I'm not saying anybody who is high around their kid is a bad parent. I'm just letting y'all know that, you know, you can be less vigilant, you know, when you are under any influence.
I want to say something to the everybody that's watching.
You can be. I'm not saying that you are 100% because weed don't affect me the way it affects, you know, it doesn't affect me or it doesn't affect us. Like it would affect a first time smoker, you know what I'm saying?
Dead
you know,
homes.
We've been able to adapt to it over time, but you know, just having little babies around me, I want to be like 100% alert. And I know me, not saying that I am dumb when I'm high, but you know, I don't pay 100% attention. I can get so focused on one thing
I feel like weed makes you less vigilant towards certain shit.
Mm-hmm.
Weed is not that strong of a drug. It's not that heavy of a drug. And even the law, will tell you that if you want to always go by like the law and shit. It's not even that type of drug to where you just like all the way out of it. It makes you less vigilant towards certain shit that you just know deep down you don't give a fuck about for real as a whole. Your kids, like, I feel like if the weed is making you less vigilant over some shit like that, you don't need to be smoking that shit at all. Like,
right?
It make you less vigilant towards like shit that you like ain't really tripping about because you relax, you chilling. But when it's like something serious, like your kid, or for example,
hold on.
For example, think about the times you smoke before work. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I've never smoked before work.
I've never done that.
So that's what I'm saying. I believe that it affects me in that way to where I can't perform as well as I need to.
I'm just saying, so like, think of, well, okay, not yeah. you, not you then, but yeah. just people, period. Like, think about people who smoke before work. They smoking, but they know, like, oh, I got to be out the house by this type of time.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So that's something that they care about, like something that is serious, like it's their whole ass job or it's their whole ass baby. So it's like, okay, I'm smoking, but shit, let me go fix my kid something to eat or something like that. Ooh, like it's like that. Like that's how I feel about it. How I feel, like,
there is no way. I swear.
So quite okay. It was a question here. Latoya Rudd asked, saying, "What age does it become okay to be high around your kids?"
There is no correct age to be high around your child.
Y'all think so?
No, not for real. I think.
So say your child turned like
grown,
15, 16.
It's for me. It's more so of a respect thing. I think with children, if it's my child, I don't never want them to see. I don't, not saying that I'm supposed to be the perfect mother all the time, never drunk, never high. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is that I, respectfully for them, I wouldn't want them to see me under a consistent state of being high. Because you know when somebody is high.
Well, I know me personally, and y'all can attest to this because we smoke together damn right. every day. I'm the exact same person when I'm high. As when I'm sober. I just smell like weed now. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, when I'm drunk, I'm nicer. I'm
quite sober.
I don't even drink. Like, I don't even get drunk. I don't even drink. So that I ain't got to worry about that.
Where I'm plugging in at, Joe. I don't know if you guys are probably listening or not, or paying attention. Mm-hmm. But if you guys want to place a phone call real quick, man, listen, I'm going to give y'all the number.
Like, comment,
not
share.
Not abuse this motherfucker.
Please.
The number is... For the calls, the number for the calls is 816-266-8452. That number is 816. That's a text number. Oh, okay. Number is 816-266-8452.
We need to
run a number, bro. That's a text number. Text number and call number is two different things. People abuse a lot of those things, so we have to just keep it different for different reasons. So the number for... calling right now is 816-266-8452. If you have anything you want to call in and let the Popular Ignorance Gang know about how you feeling about this fucking episode we doing right now, call in right now. Let me know what's up.
Von Shea said, "Quay better get the Mother of the Year every year the way you talking." Well, at least I'm having conversations before I have children instead of after I do. Because y'all having kids and not knowing how y'all going to raise them. So, I'm sorry. Hopefully, I will. By the time I'm ready to have kids, I got all my shit together.
Hey, man, listen. If you feel some kind of way, my nigga, call in.
Listen,
talk to us.
Hopefully, I do get quite
real quick. Uh-huh. I get that. I understand that. Yeah. But I'm telling you, when you have a kid here, it's totally different to what you
understand.
Expect.
And everybody tells me, like,
you're gonna, there's gonna be some shit that you're gonna be like, damn, I wasn't like kids will fucking like they. You learn shit. Every day, something new, different. Nothing. Like you be thinking, like, oh, when I'm be a parent, like most people, I don't get. They be like, oh, I know I'm gonna be a bum ass. Then the kid get to here and they be like,
fuck,
what the fuck?
Yeah,
like, it's literally you. Literally gotta go day, especially when they're young. You gotta go day by day because they switch up. So just like
that's
you,
true.
Life changes. Like shit is gonna change.
I completely agree.
Hey man, listen, hold on, guys. We got a phone call right now, man.
Oh, we got a phone call.
We got a phone call right now.
That's what I'm saying.
Who's on the phone with us, man?
What's up? What's up?
Hey, I'm on the show.
Yeah, you on the show right now.
Yeah, you on the show.
Okay, I was.
Who is that? Who is this, man? Who?
Is that our brother, Reggie?
Hold on. Where you from, Reggie? Hold on, where you from, man? Talk to me.
I'm from Jacksonville, Florida. I'm watching.
Oh, Jacksonville. All right, man. What's going on with you?
Shout out Jacksonville.
Shout out Jacksonville. Let me know how you feeling.
It's Reggie, bro.
Man, I would say I can respect some things about, you know, what Quay got going on with what she's saying, man, to be honest. Yes.
Thank you, Reggie.
Being in a different state. Hold on, wait a minute. Let me finish. Being in a different state does mean at different points in time you are a little less, you know, vigilant to what's going on. But that being said, you want to be very careful what you tread on telling people about raising their kids on a consistent state, because I can tell you for one that I've watched my nephew for over 5 months straight by myself. I'm the type of dude that I have to be high unless you're going to get a motherfucker like D when he's sober. You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, there was not a point in time within the time that I was actually watching my nephew that he was without me watching him, without having what he needed, without me being there. And then at the same time, don't act like you didn't grow up in these types of situations. And if you didn't, then I apologize, because I don't mean it in that way. But we niggas, this how you grow up. Sometimes you can, yeah, that's why you can look to your parents and be like, oh, this motherfucker high than a bitch.
Look, y'all
successful. Y'all getting on the grind. Y'all doing what y'all got to do.
Shout out.
Everybody come from a fucked up situation. situations every now and again.
Talk your shit.
So I say be careful where you test them water.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm loving the conversation.
Thank you, Reggie, man.
Listen,
man.
Listen, Reggie, man, we appreciate you, man. We thank you for calling in with your input, man.
Thank you.
I love you, brother.
Thank
you, man. Thank you.
Thank you, man. Keep calling in, man.
Almost definitely. Y'all stay on the grind, now. Y'all stay on the grind.
For sure.
Definitely, man. Thank you, man. Hey, listen. We appreciate you, man.
See, now y'all can call in. Pitch up a little bit
later, man. Thank you.
I'm going to share the shit. I don't want you all hollering about it.
Yeah, man. Like you. Thank you, man. Appreciate you, man. All right, man.
All
right, man. So, listen. If you guys want to call and leave a goddamn comment.
Yeah,
if y'all want to talk about 816-266-8452.
Join the shit talking.
I can agree.
Join the shit talking right now.
I don't want to tell anybody how to raise. I don't want to tell anybody how to raise their child. I just want to be able to speak from a child's standpoint. When you are a child, when you are somebody's child, you can speak for how you want it to be raised. So it's not that I'm speaking on parenting. I'm speaking in a child's point of view. You know, I, as a child, wouldn't have wanted to see my mama high or drunk every day. That's not something I would have wanted to
see. Me personally, okay, I won't say my mom. My dad. When I see my dad high, yo, shit was so much funner. Like you said, I'm a lot nicer person when I'm higher, when I'm drunk or whatever.
Right.
My dad was like that type of shit. Like when he was high or drunk, a lot nicer person. Like when he was drunk,
My pops was the same exact person that he was when he was sober. That's exactly how he was when he was drunk or high. It didn't really matter. So therefore, I didn't know that there was a difference. I used to watch him drink this shit, but I just never really.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't feel disrespected or whatever you want to call it, because we still in traffic every day. We still racing up and down the street. We still doing everything that we did while he was drunk or high, whatever you want to call it.
Right. And everybody's lifestyle, everybody's, you know, experience childhood with somebody being high or drunk is completely different. Every time I seen somebody high or drunk, they were being aggressive, they were being loud, they were being annoying, they were being dumb. So it's like every experience that I've gotten with it has been disrespectful. So it's like, if you seen your dad smoke every day and he was the same person when you grew up, you're going to be the same person when you're high. So it's again, I was confused because it's not something that I've seen on a consistent. So my childhood growing up was so much different than a lot of other people's, apparently. And I'm not telling y'all, again, y'all are bad parents for smoking. Please do whatever y'all think is best for you and your child.
I feel like
raise your kid exactly how you want to, but be able to take criticism from other people, because we can help.
You shouldn't be smoking in front of your child, though. Like, I know my kids ain't going. I'm not gonna be smoking in front of them. Like, go in the room right now. I'm about to like that type of shit. But I'm not gonna like puffing like while they running around
puffing
like,
the fat ass butt. Yeah, we ain't doing that.
You know what I'm saying? Not until they become like damn near adults type time.
I was just gonna say, I forgot what I was gonna say.
Y'all talk about me.
But I was, for real, I was just like, everybody's experience is different, because like when my father, like, I seen the shit that he done, and it had a negative impact on me, and then I did.
Oh shit, y'all, we got another call. Go ahead, finish.
Then I did another.
Answer it. Go ahead.
Go ahead, Latoya. Yeah. Give me 1 second. Let Montel expunge on this thought. We're gonna get right to your comment.
I was just about to say shit. Like, I had a negative experience, and then I did it, and then like I seen it, and now it's just like it's just like I seen the traits that I seen my dad go through,
right, and then
spawned off on me, and you gotta be aware that like the shit that you do in front of your kids, they're gonna pick up on that. Kids are really fucking smart.
Right.
If you don't think so, they like whatever you do. And you're doing it in front of them, they're going to pick up on that, and they're going to think that's what's right.
Yeah.
And they don't think that's okay.
And I want to comment towards that whenever we're done talking to Latoya.
Hey, man, who we talking to, man? What's going on?
It's Toya.
Hey, girl.
Hey, Toya, what's going on, man? We see you in the comments going crazy, girl. What's going on, man? How you doing?
You looking good in that Popular Ignorance shirt.
Yeah, man, exactly. We see you in the Popular Ignorance shirt, man. What's going on with you? How you doing?
But no, for real though, like, you know, you're my girl, but I just don't agree. But I'm not mad at you for having a different opinion. I just feel like, as long as you're not sitting in front of your child, puffing in their face, killing them, then.
Well, that shit is dangerous.
It shouldn't be, unless you going beyond your limit. As long as you know your limit, if you go in the other room, your kid in the other room taking a nap, and you in your room, and you hit the ball a couple times,
of course,
and you like, lights or whatever, I feel like, you know what I'm saying? that's acceptable.
Ain't those are the scenarios I'm referring to. Like, your child sleep, your child's away. I was specifically speaking to when you're watching a child run around and stuff. You know, that's when I'm speaking to. Kids away, kids chilling, you know, they in the other room watching a movie. You know, I'm like, look to the left, look to the right. You know, hit your blood real quick.
You know how that goes. 1 minute, you gotta think about it, like, in real time. Like, 1 minute they might be in another room, next minute they running in this room. You know, kids, they don't know how to fucking see still.
Facts. Facts.
But I'm saying, you know what I'm saying? They might be in the other room when you smoking. You initially got high, but you will still be high when that child running the room saying, "Mommy, can I have some?"
And that's what I was saying.
That's facts.
And you just, you know what I'm saying, as long as you know your limit, you're still going to be fine. That child's going to be fine. Y'all not going to be in danger. You know what I'm saying? Because you hit the wall a couple times when they run out of the room.
You fucking up.
That's facts. Thank you. I definitely appreciate your input, and I thank you for just, you know, enlightening me with that. So I definitely do appreciate you calling in and, you know, giving your input. We do appreciate you. We love you as our top fan.
Man, LaToya, man, we appreciate you, man, for being a top fan. As I said, a top fan.
Yeah, man, thank you for all the support, man. You've been tapping in since literally the first episode.
Yeah, the first episode, man. We appreciate your support, man.
LaToya with the soft voice, for real.
You really don't understand, man. Please call in next episode, man. Matter of fact, call in versus... call in during D-Lo and D-Lo. You dig what I'm saying?
Let matter of fact, yeah, please.
You dig what I'm saying?
Man, y'all be wilding. I don't know if I
want to
call when y'all do
D-Lo. You can ask us whatever you want.
You can ask us whatever you want.
It's the shit that will fuck with your rainbow.
You dig what I'm saying?
When Martell going to have his segment? Martell have a chill segment. I could call
Martell,
that.
You do need a segment.
Martell got a segment coming out, man. We definitely got something called Ignorant Motherfucker coming up with this.
Because I got a lot of ignorant ass stories. And
he got a lot of ignorant jokes, too.
I'm just an open ass. I'm an open ass girl. I do need a segment because I just be saying some shit.
Hey, who else want to call in on God? I'm fucking with this call.
Exactly. Who else?
Let's roll into our next topic.
Let's go to the next segment.
Should we go to this first one or this one right here?
Which one?
The first one is about.
Let's go to Breeze because we said we was gonna go to Breeze. Wait, what?
Yeah, Bree Jackson. Yeah. Okay. So I'm gonna Bree Jackson. I'm gonna read your.
Somebody calling?
No. Never mind. I have to piss, but I don't want... Never mind.
So, let me go ahead and read her. So, Bree Jackson said, in light of the constant murder and injustice against black people by white people and police officers, is it befitting of a white person who has black friends and has immersed themselves in black culture to speak on or at least acknowledge what affects the people they surround themselves with?
Yes.
Hell motherfucking yeah.
Yeah. Because it's like,
speak on it.
Because it's like they see their friends and shit, and these are they genuine friends. Like, they probably didn't grow up with these people, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, this man is white and then his friends are black, you
exactly.
know what I'm saying? But
it just happened to be like that.
But yeah, it just happens. But like, and if they feel for their friend, like, mm-hmm. they feel for their friend, like how friends feel for each other.
Exactly.
Then, of course, they ain't gonna be able to, like, they ain't gonna fully understand where we coming from.
Exactly.
But as far as them voicing their frustration about some shit that should be universal, because right. what happened to that man, even if it was a white cop and a black man, or a black cop and a white man, like, that's fucked up.
Police
period.
Brutality is fucked up regardless. It's
that shit fucked up. Period.
And
so if they speaking on that, then yeah, they got all. Yeah, they can speak on the shit. They can't like. They can't like
speak
they're not gonna fully understand. They can't speak for us.
Yeah,
but they can speak on injustices that they see
for
going
sure.
on, regardless of what race it is, because it's gonna be it's wrong no matter what race it is. Like,
exactly, the killing of our people. I feel like if you're gonna speak up for us, speak up for us for real. I seen a status the other day.
Is this a tag?
Is it? If it is, pull it off. Thank you. I like those things. But no, I seen a status the other day that started, as much as I agree with the Black Lives Matter movement, I also agree with, I also stand with the 1800, cut it out. If you're going to talk about Black Lives Matter, talk about Black Lives Matter. Stand on that stance and speak with us. Don't use Black Lives Matter as a way to get people talking about your topic. Be sure to mention our topic and your topic separately. If you feel strongly about both of them, let them stand in their own. And I feel like if you are dating, like his wife, George's wife was white. She said, we should forgive the police officer. Girl, fuck you and that. We're not forgiving shit. That's what I want you to speak up against the prejudices that go against me. If I have a Hispanic friend and they're sitting here talking about telling me that their cousin or their uncle or their dad or their mom got deported, then I can't speak to being deported. I've never had anybody been deported ever in my life. But can I stand with her? Can I stand with her at those protests? Can I tell her she has the right to feel that the way that she does? The way that they're treating those people is completely wrong. Yes, because I have empathy. Anybody who's with us, if you gonna be with us, you gotta have empathy for our situation. And our situation is fucked up right now, and we can't do it ourselves. We need the help of other people. We can't.
I kind of heard you while I was pissing, but I've been on this rant all day.
Basically, Bree Jackson's question was, should the people who immerse themselves in black culture or hang around black people speak on the topics that, you know, we face every single day?
Yeah.
Definitely. It takes a village, my nigga.
Think about what my boy Scott just did. You know what I'm saying? Like, he checked,
as far as what?
He just checked a bitch of his own race. You know what I'm saying?
Period.
Because she was trying to basically, like, say, like,
make our situation.
Yeah, she's trying to diminish this shit. You know what I'm saying? And he like, nah, this ain't that. You know what I'm saying? I've been living in Kansas City my whole life. I grew up around black my whole life. Nah, this ain't that. But you don't understand what he said. He said what you don't understand what they going through, because you probably live in some fucking nice neighborhood out in Kansas somewhere.
Exactly.
Scott said that shit because he grew up with us. You know what I'm saying? Like, he grew up in the shit with us. Now he may not be black.
Yeah.
I mean, he got blonde hair and blue eyes, but you know what I'm saying? But he know what's up.
And he's using his privilege as a what is it called?
Platform.
There we go.
Talk about what's going on within our culture, within our generation.
To me, I don't think it's about having empathy. It's just about
being
real about it. It's like, you gotta have a I was having a conversation with,
not sympathy, but empathy. Not, like, not, I feel where,
well,
you're coming,
it's
from.
Just like, yeah, but it's just at the end of the day, they're not truly going to fully understand the effect that we go through.
And that's
it's the fact that it's like, I applaud you for
it's not their fault,
but you know what you should be doing in this situation.
Yeah, right, but right. It's just like, I applaud you for speaking out, because not everybody, and like, I'm like one of the people, she's actually one of my exes. Oh, she's been ranting like crazy, and it's just like, you can't change everybody's mind, bro. Like for real, like, you can do as much as you can, but the ignorance in people is just strictly gonna come out. But it's like, if you can have a lot of people, like, if you're a minority and you understand what we're going through, or you understand just as a minority what you're going through, mm-hmm. if somebody outside of that race is just like, okay, I can't speak on the aspect of, like, the experience based off of what you're going through, it's just like, but I understand, like, I'm aware of the realness of what's going on.
Yeah.
It's like, I'm with you. That takes a lot of courage.
Yeah.
For real.
It takes
when it comes to white people speaking on the problems that the black community is having, mm-hmm. it takes a lot of courage for them.
Because
it's
agreed.
Because some of them, they're with us, but they won't speak out because it's like, at the end of the day, I'm not black. I don't understand what you're saying. I don't think that should stop you. But that's the realist. That's realistic.
But I feel like only speaking out and doing a tweet only do so fucking much, my nigga.
Yeah.
I'm so fucking tired of protesting and turning the other fucking cheek. I'm so tired of it. Listen, I'm gonna say this shit.
Okay,
we're
gonna talk some shit.
I truly
mean this shit from the bottom of my heart. I'm so happy them people in Minneapolis is rioting. I'm so happy the people down here is protesting and rioting.
Facts.
I'm so happy about this shit because it's like, I'm so fucking tired of protesting and turning the other fucking shit.
No justice, y'all wanna know, peace, no racist police.
Continue being treated like shit, my nigga. You dig what I'm saying?
Y'all want to know what the fuck unravels my
year after year, my nigga. Shit's stupid. This shit's dead.
Y'all want to know what the fuck unravels my wood, bro?
What's up?
Please speak on it.
When people be like,
please, I know what you finna say.
When they be like, oh, black lives only matter when white people kill us, this and the third, like, bro.
Let me speak on it.
What,
like,
bro?
Let me speak on it.
This ain't when that. Black people kill black, but it's like, you know, black lives only matter.
Listen, hold up.
Let him finish his point.
I was about to get in my bag.
Let him finish his point. Because niggas ain't killing niggas for jogging down the street. You doing them?
Period.
Like, niggas ain't doing none of that. Niggas are.
Y'all know
niggas,
street politics.
Niggas had their problems with niggas for whatever.
Politics.
For whatever. It's so many different politics.
That goes back years.
This nigga probably just smoked my brother.
But it's deeper than that, though.
I'm just saying, like, this nigga probably smoked my brother. He probably smoked my cousin. You know what I'm saying?
And, like, then we call the police to help us, and they kill us.
You know what's crazy, though? It's really deeper than that. It's because of, like, think about the situations they put us in. Think about the neighborhoods they put us in.
This shit didn't just start.
We strictly off survival. You dig what I'm saying? So in survival, what the fuck you gonna do? A lion gonna do what? What is a lion gonna do? Eat a fucking gazelle. You dig what I'm saying?
Period. And you bitches is gazelles. Y'all fast, but y'all ain't. Nigga,
if we go to the hood right now, what you gonna see? Liquor stores, gun stores, rat bitches. Literally. That's it.
Torn down houses, fucked up shit. This shit didn't just start today. This shit didn't start in the 60s.
When this shit been going on.
When they freed us, they literally said, the only way that you're free is if you follow our rules. And then gave the slavers fucking police badges. That's all they did. That's gave exactly slavers police badges. That's police literally from. Where the police came from, to keep people enslaved.
My whole thing is this, man. Listen. And
how can we fix a problem we didn't fucking start? We didn't put ourselves in impoverished neighborhoods. We didn't not teach us how to read and write. Shit. We didn't put us in jail. We didn't put us here. We didn't we've sat in, we've rioted, we've rolled buses, we've protested, we've marched, we've gave speeches, we've done everything. What else is there for us to do? What else is, can y'all do something? Can y'all help us?
Listen, it's not even so much that. They doing something. If they want to do something to help, cool. Fuck that.
We were united before we were apart.
Lil Wayne said something earlier this week, and motherfuckers really on his neck about it. It's not so much about tweeting. It's not about wearing a fucking shirt.
Mm-hmm.
It's not about that shit, bro. It's so much deeper than that. It's not about turning the other cheek no more. It's not about protesting. My nigga, we have to get up and show these motherfuckers really what we talking about. Exactly. My nigga, still in the Constitution today, it says we are 3/5
of a
man. But
what is that going to change?
What is protesting?
I'm not even saying anything about protesting. So like,
let him finish.
This is my thing. Like I said before, the negative energy you put into this world is going to come back.
Wrong.
It is. It is. You're going to fight fire with fire. What's going to happen?
A bigger fucking fire so they can pay attention.
You're bringing attention to it.
Exactly.
But what the fuck is that going to change?
So what is
At the end of the day, they looking at it. What people are saying.
Everything we know so far. What does that change?
What does it change?
What the fuck are we doing now? What does that change? We rioting.
Don't ask my question. You can't ask my question with a question, bro.
Yeah.
But my thing is,
what has protests?
Nothing has changed.
Turn the other cheek.
That's because we said we're united, but we're really not united.
When we
all divided. If we go down there protesting, is that not united?
I'll stop because I'm gonna keep going.
If we down there protesting, is that not being united?
We all want to come and go,
but there's half
of the fucking people there is protesting, the other half is rioting. What the fuck is how's that reunited? We all have a common goal, but we all want to achieve it a different way.
Exactly. So
why are they rioting?
Exactly. So
because we want change, but we all have.
We don't have to be.
This is what I'm saying. We all have the common goal, but everybody there is wanting to achieve it a different way.
So just because you're going about it the Malcolm way, you're going about it the Martin way. That makes
sense. I'm not even saying about the Malcolm way. I didn't say shit about protest.
That's basically what you're saying though, because you're going about it the Martin way. Hold on, hear me out. By saying that them rioting and doing that shit is wrong. When Malcolm gets said by any means necessary.
By any means.
They don't respect us by any means necessary. You're sitting there telling me, hold on.
Give us one second.
Hold on, get this point out. Hold on.
Answer.
Listen, I'm going to answer your phone. Just give me one second to get this point out. I'm gonna get to you in one second, please. I can get this point out. So, Martin said what? Turn the other cheek. Listen to what the fuck they talking about. Don't fight back. Don't do none of that shit.
We've been doing that shit for how fucking long? Popped him and everybody else. They killed Malcolm. They killed every
George Floyd's a prime example of that shit. Niggas sitting there saying I can't fucking breathe. And what happened to this nigga?
Every leader we've had, they killed.
What else are we talking about? I'm so fucking tired of protesting and marching and doing this goofy dumb shit, wearing shirts and shit. Go out there and riot, tear that shit up, and do that shit.
Martin said something else too.
He integrated our people into a burning building.
Exactly. So Martin was saying, become financially stable to where your voice can be heard, because the protesting, that is the beginning of the march of the protest. That's the beginning of trying to make change, but it has to be followed up. And like I said,
you're gonna keep spending
money with these motherfuckers, and you're gonna keep on putting money in their pockets. These people that's making all these fucked up laws to keep these people in power after they fuck up, then you to blame too. You gotta quit supporting these companies like Walmart and like all these other.
But here's the thing.
We got somebody on the line. Let's talk. Let's get to this comment.
I want to speak to what Montel's saying.
All right. So hey, what's going on? Who's calling?
It's me again.
What's going on, Latoya? What's going on, man? Talk to us real quick. Let us know your comment.
Okay.
All right, no, no, no. I just really had a question to, first of all, to, you know, calm you guys down a second, give you some time to, you know.
Oh, this shit? No, we're not mad. It's just get good, anyway, good heated debate.
This is a good discussion, right?
It is.
This is a good discussion.
Hey, what do you guys think about the, I don't know if it's a, I don't know if you would call it a rumor or a theory, but people saying that the first rioters in Minneapolis were actually undercover cops. And
there were.
Like, that was a fact.
Those were facts. That they're trying to make
it. I didn't even hear what she said.
Hold on, Latoya, can you repeat that one more time for me, please? I don't really hear you. Can you speak up for me?
I said, what do you think about the theory that people were saying that the first rioters in Minneapolis were actually undercover cops?
The first
burning building.
Yeah, the auto parts store was set on fire by a police officer. So they're trying to make, I think that they're trying to make us
look like the savages.
Look bad.
Started
because we didn't start looting and rioting until they start some shit on fire.
Hold on, Latoya, go ahead.
No, that's it. I just had that question.
No,
I just wanted to help
top
out.
God damn it. All right,
That was her question was, how do you guys feel about the police officers who started the
shit? Sounds about right to me.
It sounded about right.
I never heard that.
But
that
you,
rumor.
Yeah, do y'all see what we're doing?
I don't know if I believe that.
All right, so hold on. All right, I got to hang up with you. We're about to talk about this on the podcast real quick so everybody else can be engaged and shit like that. But listen, I appreciate you calling. And please call back again for D-Lo and D-Lo, man.
Hey, like, comment, share.
We need to hit them from all different angles. It don't need to be just one way of doing things. So, yes, we need to riot. Yes, we need to protest. But, yes, we also need to get financially stable. Yes, we need to get voted in office. Yes, we need. But we have to start somewhere. All these different things that we're doing right now are all things that are going to push us to get change. So we can't just say, oh, let's exclude rioting, but do these positive things. No, do the negative things, do the positive things, do whatever you need to do to get that change.
I'm not even saying I'm with protesting or rioting. My thing is, my whole spiel about it is with the shit that happened in Minneapolis. Mm-hmm. I understand the frustration. That shit pisses me off. That I understand the anger. But looting a fucking business, running through Target, that shit is not related to this black man getting killed. Now, when they set the police department on fire, uh-huh. That's understandable. Okay. That's relatable. I can understand. I can get with that. Uh-huh. But you want to loot Target and destroy all these businesses, talking about let's hit their pockets. Y'all motherfuckers pay taxes. Them niggas is still gonna get rich regardless if you burn it down or not. That insurance check is gonna hit. They just gonna look at you laughing at the same fucking
quake. Say what you're about to say.
Do you not know that Target and Walmart, all of those are ran by the people who enforce the laws that are staying? The most Target, Walmart.
Hold on, y'all. We got another call. Phone lines is pinging.
Target and Walmart are behind the people who help. Build prisons and shit.
All right, so, man. Who's giving us? Oh, go ahead.
They're just as bad. No, go ahead. Let them talk.
Who's calling in, man? Let me know.
This is Bree.
What's up, Bree? What's going on,
Bree? What's up, girl? Talk to me, Bree.
We actually on your comment.
Where you from?
Martell talking about. Oh, I'm from North Carolina.
North Carolina. What's going on, man? Talk to me. Let me know your comment.
So, Greenville. To Martell talking about Target. So they were not in support of, you know, the rioting or whatever. They was in support of the police department.
Mm-hmm.
So when you're not giving people that's out there protesting or rioting any type of milk or any type of water, of course people gonna be mad about that. So why would you even want to support a store like that that's not even helping the people of that community that is on the side of the police department?
Why are we still shopping at Walmart every day?
I can do that.
We fund Walmart's pockets, and like I'm saying, Target, all of those big stores, Tyson, all of those big name people are people who assist in building prisons to put us in. So it does start with attacking those big businesses. It starts with us shopping.
And
it
don't hurt them.
Why don't we go spend our money somewhere else?
A ton of them in this country.
Spending our money somewhere else is only gonna do. That's something else we should be doing. It's not, but we shouldn't exclude burning their shit down.
We want to talk about supporting black businesses, but yeah, we want to say hit their pockets, but yeah, we don't. We want to
support. Like, how many black supermarkets do we have?
There's not many, but you know how many are trying to come up.
I don't think that's black owned. Price Chopper.
We saying name three black supermarkets right now. Name three banks right now.
Not many
black banks.
But that's because
name three black owned stores.
That's because y'all say we support it, but y'all really don't.
Who's starting a black supermarket?
I don't think he heard what you just said.
It's not even about supporting black businesses when you have people in high places that make it a point to not want people of color to own anything, exactly. Especially in the community.
Do you know Tyson owns
especially
chicken
in the downtown area? They be like, "Oh, you a black person? You own something?" They cut that shit out. What do you mean?
They own everything.
Niggas own sugar.
Monsanto owns beans. You can't start a bean farm without Monsanto signing off on it. Tyson owns chicken. Walmart owns damn near supermarkets. There's a Walmart everywhere. Your small business, your supermarket is not going to survive if there's a Walmart next to it. So nope. There are monopolies that are out here to stop.
It's, so what do we? We weren't
in so the, at the very big. We didn't get it when Walmart began.
It's our fault that we patronize Walmart.
My question is, what as a black community can we do to change shit?
Continue what we're
stop
doing.
Stop buying from these corporations.
True, but we have to. Where are we going to go? We need to start somewhere
else. Our black
else.
Dollar has more power than you think.
We got to start down at the protests. We got to start down at the riots. We got to start.
Our black dollar has more power than you think.
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
We have to.
Because black people, we buy so much stuff all the time anyway.
Facts.
If we took away our dollar, if we took away our talent from everything, they wouldn't have anything.
If we invest in ourselves, we will have a lot
of money. If you find somebody who's trying to open up a black supermarket,
if we just pulled our dollar from everything, pulled our talent from everything, that it wouldn't change everything.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, goddamn.
But you can't.
Go ahead.
Just point me to a black supermarket though, so I can shop there.
My thing where is, but that's what I'm,
when I find one, that, then
there's none because you know why we don't invest in ourselves like that. We don't.
No, I don't think
we
so.
How many black doctors do you know? How many black lawyers do you know? How many black people do you know that's on the Supreme Court? We only had one black president.
And even then,
you said he wasn't shit.
Do you know?
You said we support shit and we really don't. But then again,
I said Obama wasn't shit strictly because
he get you
I,
said he
okay,
get
I'm hold to right here. I'm gonna hang out right here.
Matter of fact, I'm gonna give you a call back because now niggas is on my neck.
I'm hang out right
you
here.
Said he gave hope to black people.
Wait, so you don't said
that's the hope we need. Ain't that's how we supposed to change?
Listen,
if we really want to change something, it's gonna have to start at a younger age. It's gonna have to start in the household.
Hold on, Quay.
We're like they said on Puff Puff. Like they said on Puff Puff and Laugh. Most of the black community is preached on being athletes and wanting to be in the music industry. How many black people do you know that's gonna be like?
Do you know why that's bullshit?
How's it bullshit?
Strictly because what the fuck is hope done for us? What is hope done?
Hope everybody.
LeBron is giving you the hope. You can go to the NBA. Odell Beckham give you the hope. You can go to the NFL. Obama gave you the hope. You can be the president. What the fuck is that change?
Hope doesn't change anything.
That ain't changed shit.
But what I am, the changes I am seeing is that in 2016, in 2020, how many first generations do we got graduating from college? How many black entrepreneurs we have? Shit. We are investing in ourselves.
Hold on one second, Carla. Let Quay get this bar
it's
off.
It doesn't happen that fast. It's going to take time. It's going to happen from us. The class that's graduating right now, that's 2020, those are the people who are going to be in offices. Those are the people who are going to open up businesses. Those are the people who are, but that is all in the future. Yes, we have to build each other up, but that all, grocery stores don't come out after 6 months. They don't just pop up.
And I'm not expecting it to change in a day.
Hold on, go ahead, Carla. Who's this?
Reggie.
What's up, man?
What's going on, Reggie? Man, you called back from Jacksonville, baby. What's going on, Reggie?
Man, I'm talking to Montel this time. Monty, how you doing, bro? You seem a little frustrated.
What's up, Reggie, man? What's up?
I just called in to let you know, bro, that everything positive that you're talking about, it makes a piece of sense to me, just in a very small way, because I get it. The good seeds you sow is what you get out of the world. But at the end of the day, this is no longer about, you know, the good and the evil, man. Well, the way to do it, should I say. There's such thing as a righteous anger, bro, and you got to be sensible of that. It's okay to get mad and beat up the motherfucker who raped the bitch. It's the same thing in my eyes, just in my eyes, you know. And then at the same time, you got to think about, is it just about fixing for all of y'all? Is it just about fixing this country anymore? Or is that really the sense that we're making of this right now? I mean, because at the end of the day, I'm down with financial financial growth and a whole nice little war where we annex the land, you know, hook up with our brothers and sisters in Mexico. Ooh, boom, we got us a hell of a fight. You know what I mean? Yeah. But at the end of the day, you go look at the homeland we got over there. Akon done built the whole motherfucking city. You understand? One fucking man done built the whole goddamn city, and we over here hollering about how these white... Get these white people their shit, and let's leave. Fuck these niggas. They stole us from home in the first place, and not in the whole time we've been here has a nigga shown up in a canoe and a spear to pick our ass up, because they've been waiting for our ass to get home. It's just a thought.
Hey, man, Reggie, man, listen, man, we appreciate your comment. We definitely appreciate your input, man.
This nigga speaks. I 100% agree with Reggie,
give you a call. If you could, give us a call back next week, man. Let us know some more of your input, man. Keep watching the show. Like, share, comment, man. We appreciate you.
Hopefully, I must say most nothing.
All right, man. Thank you, man. Appreciate you.
I definitely agree with you, though, Montel. I do agree that we do need to build business in our things, but that stuff is gonna come later. First, we gotta get the laws built and stuff, and then we can create our own. We gotta get equality in order to be able to create our own. Cause we did have a Black Wall Street, we did have Black Banks, we did have all of these things, and they burned that shit to the ground. So before we can build that shit, we gotta make sure these motherfuckers know exactly how we feel, and make sure these motherfuckers know not to fuck with us no more. If they know not to fuck with us, we can build all that shit and have our own. And I completely agree. We gotta start building that, but that's gonna come from motherfuckers our age. That's not gonna come from our parents, and it's not gonna come from people younger.
Because
it's gonna
come
from us. Exactly. It's gonna come from. We gotta make that change. And with us graduating, and with us starting businesses,
I want to keep expunging y'all, but we gotta come on.
You know.
One last point. I agree. I agree. And I, like I said, I'm not disagreeing with the writings. Right. I thought about this shit all night last night, because I've been ready for this fucking podcast. I'm just thinking, like, positive. I'm not talking about just going ahead, marching, protesting and shit. I'm thinking about logically, how we can get under these motherfuckers' skin is if we get educated. We need more professors. We need more doctors, lawyers, judges, all that shit. If we really want to make a fucking impact, preach it to your kid. Like, this is one thing I'm going to tell my kid. Don't ever let your, like, I know skin color always plays, is like something you can never get away from, but don't ever let that be the reason why you can't do shit. You can do whatever the fuck you want, regardless of your fucking skin color. How long you been talking about this podcast?
5 years.
5 years. What are we doing now?
Podcast.
We're the damn best kept podcast in this fucking city. Wait, I'm doing shirts. D-Lo doing music. Quay doing her shit.
I'm motherfucking here. I'm opening a hair store.
Quay doing her shit.
I'm gonna open a hair store. I don't want
can,
to just
you
sell
can
one
only
thing. I'm
you can
everything.
Only do what the fuck you want if you put your mind. Don't let nobody tell you you cannot do shit. And I'm talking to the Black community.
Exactly.
You don't let nobody. Don't let your skin color be the reason why you can't do shit. If somebody say, "Oh, you Black, you can't do this." Bet, watch me do this.
Watch me do it.
That's what I'm getting at.
Right.
Don't just because, yeah, like I get it. And what I'm saying is, like, don't play a fire with fire. That's me personally. I'm not gonna do it, because it's like, y'all doing this shit. All right, watch this. I'm finna own this whole shit, and y'all motherfuckers gonna look at me and be like, damn.
We
this
do
nigga
need
really
more doctors
that?
And
yeah.
lawyers, but we shouldn't have to be doctors and lawyers to get respect.
We don't. We but should. It's just. But it's just.
We
should. We don't.
Should, we should be
ready. But it's just like they're not gonna.
They're
not gonna respect us until like they see they gonna.
You see,
like,
how they talk to Maxine Peterson?
Listen, guys. Go ahead.
Oh, D-Lo and D-Lo.
It's goddamn mosquitoes. It's got mosquitoes on me.
We're done.
Y'all preaching, giving these people the good goddamn gospel.
We're gonna get a segment.
No, I gotta roll two more WIWs.
Before I kick y'all off, man, I just want to say this. I appreciate both y'all.
I love y'all guys.
Yeah, I came.
We're gonna have a serious. Hey, me and Montel gonna have a serious segment.
Exactly.
Where we gonna do this?
We gonna talk some shit.
Quick.
We gonna talk some shit.
We appreciate y'all, man. If y'all, if, you want something too? Sorry, sir. Oh, well. Nah. Fuck you then. He's a,
y'all better well, talk about I some. Put my y'all finna talk about you. Some. Look, y'all finna talk about some broke bitches in the poke community. Oh,
shit. Nah, man. But listen. I am getting so listen, a message from our.
Listen, if you want to call, man, D-Lo and D-Lo, man, 816-266-8452. But if you want to send a text to say anonymous, Quay, give them that number real quick.
That is 816-282-2992. Again, that is 816-282-2992. Make sure y'all hit us up.
And the call number is 816-266-8452. Go ahead, man.
52.
Real quick, we do have merch out.
Merch.
We do have merch out. Popular Ignorant shirts. We got Ignorant Gang. Ignorant Gang. Crop top for the ladies. We have hats. We have visors. Sponsored by Nike. Yeah.
Wait, hold on.
Yeah, the visor. The visors are Nike. They're Nike visors. So the shit is legit. Like, so, you know. We're not sponsored by Nike. Baby steps. Baby steps. Yeah. But, you know, look.
Stop talking.
There's merch.
That's it. Stop talking. You said sponsored by Nike. Nick about to get us flagged. I'm trying to get that 100 million like Joe Rogan, goddammit. Hey, tell Dave.
Who the fuck is Joe Rogan?
You fucking serious?
That's a shark attack.
You know what? We'll say that conversation for another day.
Who the fuck is Joe Rogan?
Only the best podcaster out here, nigga.
Who the fuck is Joe Rogan?
He got 100 million podcasts. Let's tell you something, nigga. 100 million for podcasting, my nigga.
Yeah, he goaty. Hey, so why the fuck Kiki and P Money must have put me on this new fucking sex podcast, bro?
Who you talking about? Horrible Decisions?
Yeah, I think that's what it's called. Knocking on the back door or some shit like that.
Oh, you said who?
I think it was called like Knocking on the Back Door or some shit.
Knocking
like
on
that.
The back door, some sex shit. Okay, go ahead.
Oh, but the shit was crazy. But the bitch was on there talking about the time she ate a man's ass.
Listen, women that eat ass really push the culture forward.
Yes!
Bitches that eat ass really push the culture forward.
Bitches really do be on that shit though. Quiet as it's kept, you know what I'm saying? They be on that shit. They just be wishing that we would be like more.
Be honest about
more
it.
Accepting about it.
You know I made a post about it not so long ago, talking about like me getting my ass ate. And when I tell you, I got at least 50 likes. It was like 100 in some of my comments. Like bitches really in the mother going yeah about a nigga getting his ass ate. And I was like, damn, you bitches like doing that nasty shit.
You
bitches
like doing that shit, but it's okay though. You know what I'm saying? I like that shit. You know what I'm saying? I just think that's like some of the sexiest shit a bitch can do.
Well, getting your ass ate.
Yeah.
Or a bitch licking your ass.
A bitch licking my ass because it's like bitch because you.
And put your whole tongue in there,
please. Because you nasty.
Put like, your whole face in my ass, please. Please.
On me.
Lick me like a baby wipe.
Yeah, dead homies. You know what I'm saying? Like, because that shit, that's the shit that I like, right there. You know what I'm saying? But nah, I ain't going to lie. My inbox been going crazy for like 2 weeks now.
Really?
Yeah, ever since, or maybe 1 week.
Hold on, man. We got some calls. Now, should I call some people back, yo?
Man, please call
me. Hey, man, listen. If you still watch, I'm about to give you a call back, man. Let's see who's calling.
On God.
702. Oh, I'm not going to give you a number. I get 702 area code, man. We're going to call you back right quick. Oh, shit.
If y'all want to call in, please do. And talk some shit with us.
That's what they talking about, man.
I like how you tried to call me a burger, though. And you been on some burger shit, too. You been on some burger shit right with me. I don't even know why you trying to play me like that.
All right, let's try this 913 number. Y'all been calling us, man. I'm sorry I couldn't get to y'all calls, man. I
was... reached Justin with Ally Global Services.
Justin? All right, man. Anywho, Ally
Global
man.
Services.
Anyway, man, listen. D-Lo, what you got for us, man? What's in the goddamn... What's in the sentence today, man?
Quay just sent me some shit. You know what I'm saying? Let me hit the shit real quick.
Talk to me, man.
How do you feel about pillow talking and who does it the most?
What's pillow... Okay, classify pillow talking.
You like Dirty Mackin'? And talk about who does it the most, niggas.
Nah,
it's niggas. I'm not saying bitches don't do it.
It be bitches. I have to disagree with you. Really be bitches,
bro. I gotta go with niggas, bro. I think niggas dirty mac more than bitches. I know bitches do it. Bitches done dirty mac to get some dick before.
Dead homies, all the time.
But I just feel like niggas do it. Niggas got that shit worse than bitches, bro.
But okay, but like I said, clarify what dirty mac is. You gotta give me an example of what dirty mac is.
So for y'all who don't know exactly what dirty mac or pillow talking is, it's one and the same. But it's like... when you have to throw dirt on a man's name to get some coochie. If you got to throw dirt on a man's name just to kick it, period. Like, or if you pillow talking, telling her shit that she don't need to know, like that type of shit. Or that she didn't, like, that type of shit. And that type of shit lame. You know what I'm saying? And niggas do that shit more than females. Like, that's one thing I will say.
I just niggas got that shit worse. Because, my nigga, females literally will, like, talk wet about the female they, like, they know or cool with or that you with. Gets to strictly have you try to throw dick at them. Because, oh, I'm doing this, da-da-da-da. Look what your bitch doing.
Yep.
Type of shit. You dig what I'm saying? Yep. So, I don't really feel like if females doing more, I feel like niggas doing more subconsciously type shit. Like, it's more like, oh, you fucking with that nigga? Like, oh, that nigga did that shit? Like, oh, that's crazy.
No, I don't think niggas is even being subconscious about it.
So, you think they, like, are doing that shit on purpose?
Yeah.
Do you think it'd be more like your homies type shit or be like niggas you, like, that you're not cool with?
So, it don't,
dirty macking if y'all not cool?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
It's still dirty macking, but that's not no real nigga shit. You should never have to talk bad about another man to get some coochie, bro. Y'all know I state this shit all the time. If a bitch wants to fuck you, she's going to fuck you. It don't matter. Nothing else matters. If she want to fuck you, that's what's gonna happen. Like, you ain't gotta talk about this. You ain't gotta talk about the next man. Like, if anything, that's what's gonna turn her off. Like, that's gonna turn her off. If anything, like, that shit lame.
Touche, my nigga. I got a question.
I feel like niggas do it the most. You know what I'm saying? I feel like niggas got that shit worse than females. And I'm not saying females don't do it, because I know some females, like, okay, personally.
OG, zoom out a little bit. Zoom out a little bit.
Take some
crowd.
Well, I was trying to get
to pop the
egg.
Oh, no. Gucci.
Hey, what's the craziest rumor you heard about yourself? Or a friend?
That had a little dick. That's probably the craziest shit
I've heard. That you know, bitches say that shit when they sad anyway.
No. Okay, the craziest shit I ever heard. Well, bitches are fake pregnancies and shit like that. So that's probably the craziest shit I've ever heard. Like, I had a kid on the way or some shit.
Oh, yeah. I ain't never had nobody faking a pregnancy with me.
Yeah, that's how you know.
I never had that.
It fucked up a bitch life, nigga. That's how you know.
Thank God.
You got irritated, bro. Listen, we gotta get to that. 50th episode, we'll talk about it.
All right. Now, one more thing before we go.
What's up?
Exactly, what is a ham?
Oh, my God.
Define ham.
Just define you.
I'm not a ham, okay? I have been on some hamburger shit lately. I ain't gonna lie. I've been on some hamburger shit lately, but you ain't wanna talk.
Oh, No! I know I'm a ham ass nigga. I'll take responsibility for my hamness. I know this. Like, I know I do ham.
Okay,
shit.
So tell me what I am then,
my nigga. Like, you can, like, listen.
How am I?
Because listen, yo, you preach all day on this podcast. Fuck these bitches. Bitches ain't shit. I ain't never fall in love. Fuck them. Da 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 da. And then, little bit of good pussy niggas come your way. And it's hold on. The vibes is different. I love bitches now. I want to be with bitches now. Like, nigga, where was that nigga at? I'm not trying to.
What? Nah. Hold up.
You know I'm not lying. So go ahead and say the bullshit if you want to.
Nah, because it ain't even about the coochie. That's not what it is.
Would it be the vibes?
Yes.
Bro, shut the fuck up. I'm getting coochie.
It's not about the coochie, bro.
Bro,
it's not that.
It be the coochie.
No, bro.
So you tell me, a bitch got bad coochie and good vibes, you staying?
No.
My point exactly. So it's the coochie.
I ain't even gonna be boosting.
What the fuck is he talking about?
I ain't even gonna be boosting unless you, like, caked up or something. But that's a different story.
I mean, like six rack, like six figures a year type shit.
Yeah, but that's a different story.
But
I just don't feel like I'm a ham. Bro. I don't see how I'm a ham for liking somebody. Did that make you a ham?
No. So for all the shit you talk, then they say I fell in love in a day. So it's just like, my nigga.
Did I say I fell in love? I'm not in love.
You said it on Facebook?
No.
What'd you say?
No, it was a joke, bro. Like, it was really a fucking joke.
All right, it's a little innuendo. Whatever. I'll let you slide, my nigga.
But I'm put like this, though. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I have been on some burger shit lately. I ain't even gonna lie. I ain't even gonna lie. I'm trying to make excuses to see the girl and everything. Like,
man, I was just in the neighborhood. Though. Like, I just figured you might want some food or something.
Yeah, shit, y'all. Shit, I'm just making excuses.
What I tell you, I want to be your son, your moon, your stars.
Baby, I love you. I just want to be your sun, your moon, your stars. I just want to give you the mountains. I ain't gonna lie. I dead ass been feeling like that.
My
look,
God.
I'm finna be on some Moham shit when we get up out of here. You know what I'm saying? I ain't even finna. Matter of fact.
Oh, nigga. Man, listen, man. It's Poppin' the Ignorance, episode 16, man. This nigga D-Lo been a burger for the past 2 weeks. Man, listen, if you still watching, man, like, share, comment, man. We at BLE Studios, man. Fuck with us next week, man. Please keep taking calls. Should we go out to us all?
Let's go ahead and go out.
Yeah, niggas go ahead and play.
Because I ain't gonna even fake it. It just be like that sometimes.
You be burgering?
Yeah. Yeah, I ain't gonna lie. I've been on my paw shit lately. You know what I'm saying?
I've been on some after seven type shit.
Yeah. Right.
That's how you feeling?
Yeah.
I got you. Let me get that shit queued up real quick, man. Well, after seven, ready or not? Man, if you still watching, man, I think
after dark. That shit's about to be the quiet storm.
Oh God.
Hey, how many times, bro, have Ryan Shay been sending you like friend requests and shit over and over again?
Yeah, she has like 12 different Facebooks.
Damn, girl, how many Facebook pages you gonna make?
At this point, like, you just need to stick to one or just get off Facebook, because like Mark Zuckerberg is not fucking with you.
Why do you keep making these different Facebooks? Like, she done made like six. You keep getting blocked that fast?
I think she just like this shit at this point. Got you. I feel like she just be on there saying like the F word and stuff like that. If you know what the F word is, I'm not saying it. I'm not losing my mind. Hey, man. Hand me a song for him. Hand me a sad.
You are not one to talk, bro.
Oh, no. I know. I own with mine. You didn't own yours.
Did I not say I've been on some burger shit? I'm owning it.
Now. When I texted you earlier this week, you was like, boy, fuck you.
I said fuck you because I know it was true, nigga. Fuck that.
Man, it's for you, man.
I'll be a beggar.
Ham ass nigga, man. It's Popular Ignorance, man. Episode 16, man.
It's been real, man.
It's your boy D-Lo-816. D-Lo Money, man. We signing the fuck out.
Damn. I'll give you the sun, the rain, the moon, the stars, and the mountain. I'll give you the world. And all that you wish for. And even more. Girl, I'll love you more than you could know. And that's a sure. I climb the highest hill across the wide sea. Nothing could discourage me. And I pray that you'll be always there for me forevermore.
Collins was lit as fuck. Yeah, I tried to tell you, niggas, I should have been doing that shit.